Yeah, apparently when last we left our heroes.
I'm pretty sure there was screaming kids on the cots, there was...
Yeah, but didn't we make everyone marshal to the water?
I don't think we got to that bit. Oh, that's where we were sending
them. Are we on the seaside now?
Yeah, we're going to throw them in. We've always been on the seaside.
Oh, I don't... Well, sorry, I didn't hear the seagulls over the goblins last time.
Okay. Well, that's right. Apologies. You followed with the goblins.
I heard smoosh, smoosh, smash, smash. I am one with my people now. Yeah.
Okay, just so you're clear, you are basically on this little dot here.
Oh, it's a lovely spot.
Yep. So you are in Sandpoint. So we are up to session number 20, and everyone survived last session. Not sure how, but everyone survived last session. So because
turning,
there was a
turning something to dust, that's how I survived.
Dude, you rocked it.
And that was amazing. We shall go around the table and have people introduce themselves again. So first up we have Adam.
Hello, I'm playing Zed, the female disciplined soldier / rogue of the group. Who...
Soldier of discipline or disciplined soldier?
Kind of both. Yeah, yes. Yes. who is currently incredibly interested in how we're going to rally the forces against the goblins that are surrounding the town.
And then we have Peter.
I'm playing Willy Wong Kenobi, aspirant of the Lost Errant, practitioner of the renowned Tiger Style, and saviour of quest.
Not the Dragon Style.
Margyle, no.
Definitely not the Dragon Style.
I'm currently having issues with a... distinctly underaged member of the town.
You just can't help yourself. That's the problem.
Hey, Big Willy has some shit he's got to deal
with. The issue is Little Willy's doing the thinking.
Big Willy.
That's the issue.
Big Willy is doing the thinking.
But this remember, Free Willy is an interesting context here.
Hashtag Free Willy.
This is something that we will not discuss, and we will just look elsewhere.
Well, look at this way. It may be points where you fade to black and come with the after effects.
Don't.
No. Offspring.
No.
Yeah,
no.
Offspring.
No.
Offspring. Like offspring.
No. Give it a few years.
I look like the end. Well, look at this way. Goblins are the ones most likely to be able to have their offspring old enough to do anything in the campaign.
True.
Everyone else might have to wait a while, especially if they're elven. So, Margot.
I am playing Margot, the half hobgoblin, half gnome, undead. Who apparently has actually yet to ever pick up arms and fight for anyone in the party. I am currently off on my own to attempt to make diplomatic
overtures.
Conversations with the goblins that just killed a shit ton of children.
This just gets better.
I see how many chickens you can pick up.
While my party members saw me flee to help the goblins. So, Margo's feeling pretty good. She's never hurt a fly.
It's not suspicious at all.
As a gladiator and is super friendly to goblins that kill children, apparently.
Oh, you helped just take out those rogues in Kamigawa.
She was first in, first down.
Again, Willy had to say.
I had this conversation. I was like, no, but didn't I? And he's like, no. But I did that.
No.
But didn't I?
Because I remember
you. No.
Right.
I have never swung literally anything I own.
Okay.
I've never even managed to raise my shield effectively. I now have reactive shield. Let's see if that helps.
Do it.
I don't think it will help.
First thing is, make sure you have a shield.
Oh, yeah. I do have a shield.
And second thing, make sure you're actually holding the shield.
See, now that is questionable. But I'm apparently not using my sword, so, you know, I probably have room.
Sword, pike, hammers. She's got the lot. Just never put one off. She is literally a walking little Swiss Army knife.
What do we need for this situation?
Like, oh, good one, you can't quite get your finger off to pull it out. You're like, come on, come on. Right, it's listen. not just
true. She's a Swiss Army knife, but you're using it as a bottle
opener. It's all a nail. I'm a hammer, right?
Your socials.
Look Swiss at all these blazers you can use. Nope, I'm just going to use an open
one. Yeah, let's just try and make some friends with some alcohol.
So the next person around we have is Morgan.
Hi there, I'm playing Quest the Goblin Bard. I'm running around Sandpoint, which has just been attacked by goblins, trying not to get noticed.
As a goblin.
Working well. I'm very loud.
How much longer is your disguise up for?
It's gone.
It lasted an hour. I walked in wearing it.
Yeah.
And he's been here for more than an hour.
Attacked.
Yes.
It was down.
This is why his hood is very, very low.
Yeah, I had to change my character description to make sure I was wearing the gloves with the fingers.
And so the next person around we have is Josh.
So I'm playing Parry Hotter, the tankiest wizard known to man. Also now known as the badass of the group of after I grabbed this poor little goblin and turned him to dust.
Yeah. Man of the match.
Yeah.
Last fight.
Haven't you got the most goblin kills so far?
Probably.
Yeah.
MVP.
Durza wanted to go ham at him, and I'm just there going, no, I've got this.
He stole my kills.
I know, he kept doing it. It was fun.
Not only goblins, but I think about a dozen of the townsfolk.
Yeah, there was like a dozen townsfolk collateral damage as well. That was.
So
at least I didn't kill a child.
Yeah, at least you didn't catch a child. That would be terrible.
There's limits, and come on.
According to my dear friend.
You pointed that out.
I said goblin. I didn't say kill goblin.
I'm just waiting for the witness reports.
Yeah.
That's right, because...
Hey, I'm a goblin.
They'll trace mine back.
Obviously,
because they're all scored.
Because let's be really
but
clear.
There's going to be this one little child that has his head cut off.
Yeah, because what's actually happened was you two went off to this corner, and one of you went off to parley with the goblins, and the other one hacked a child in two. I'm just a little bit concerned about the reputation of the group right now.
I didn't kill anyone.
I don't think the noose is going to care.
The noose won't.
Meanwhile, Stefan has now been hired as the new priest.
Hey, now that we've killed children, and we've also killed,
oh God.
And we've also killed a whole lot of just adults and stuff, and should we put our hands up and go, by the way, we're Pathfinders?
I'm not against that. Yeah. I'm the hobgoblin representative of the Pathfinders.
You're in a group of goblins right now. I wouldn't say that.
They love me.
Feel free to tell the goblins you're a Pathfinder.
So, moving on.
Yeah, moving on.
Then we have M.
Hi, I'm playing Duzar, the
Child Slayer.
No! As far as he's aware, he was following his dear friend around, who was hunting out
dear
the goblin.
Dear friend? Oh, come on.
No.
You've been rejecting Margo for months.
It feels like years.
Margo's been dry.
Please continue. Yep.
Who was hunting out the hiding goblins, helping me get a few kills
with
in.
Nothing but success. Like, you killed every goblin.
There was one that got away.
Yeah, except for the one that...
But Margo's getting it.
Yeah, but your Margo's getting it, but, you know, she didn't seem quite willing to stab it either.
Margo's getting something.
Deuce is going to kind of keep his eye out for one that got away. It should have a nice, axe slash through its back.
Yeah.
Because he improvised his...
Get a picture of that guy, didn't you?
Didn't you throw the goblin...
I think I,
or whatever
missed...
he was.
What do you think? I think I'm missed killing him by one or two hit points.
No, the one that turned to dust was the one that was riding the goblin dog.
I had to improvise my throwing axe. Orc neck splitter.
That's right.
I don't understand, because it's the same size as a hand axe.
See, so amusingly, that was what might have happened if you had waited long enough.
No.
Goblins at the cathedral.
Goblins at the cathedral. No, they didn't get that far.
Thank goodness.
And I think you guys, you Did you guys have to head off before quite the end of the fight?
No, there was those.
Oh, it was you guys.
It was Stefan.
Stefan was on.
Oh, Stefan was
right, cool.
I refuse.
Stefan was just like jumping in the cathedral, then jumping out of the cathedral, then jumping back
he
in the cathedral.
He was looking after the people. He's in no trouble.
Very priestly duty.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Well, as I said, he's the new priest of the town.
There's
a vacancy.
After I found that sneaky arrow that I've...
So
combat ended with the goblins rushing out the gates.
Yep.
And the hobgoblin. So
I didn't mean to.
So the rest of you have been around trying to deal with the mess and confusion that have been left over.
Mm-hmm.
The screaming of the parents, the children.
Uh-huh. They'd be loud.
It can be quite loud.
Yeah.
So not quite as scenic as the music would portray.
But the band
played the whole way through.
Yeah. Well,
but the bear was safe.
The band members were safe.
Wouldn't surprise me if he accidentally broke a leg or had some other unfortunate things.
The mayor. Give him time.
We need a hand.
Didn't he grapple you though? Like
grapple. I think the word is grope.
Yeah, he definitely grappled you.
There was much groping.
Really unfortunate if he tripped coming down those stairs.
Oh, that's gonna happen.
Oh, yeah.
he'll get his.
All right.
Okay.
But that's where we were at, and you found the. You did the medicine on the priest, and while removing an arrow, you found that they were literally, one of them literally had his name on it.
Right. One was definitely not goblin craft.
That's right.
And okay. It had his name inscribed on it.
I'm pretty sure we know who it was.
No, we don't. No, we don't.
We didn't
see a shot from the elf, so we don't know where it came from.
At the moment... Only one person knows that the arrows that hit him were suspicious.
Oh, yes. Right.
Yeah, yeah.
And even then, it's like that heroic
suspicious.
Ranger elf type, whatever she was, leaping from roof to roof, raining death down on goblins.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think would be our first suspect.
No.
Put it this way: if when you meet her, you'll probably understand that if you wanted him dead, he'd be dead already.
And hence he is.
And wouldn't need to be sneaky. Wouldn't need to be sneaky about it.
She would have killed him literally in the street if she wanted to.
And who knows about the elf? Who saw the elf?
I think we saw the elf.
Okay, so as you're seeing the aftermath of things quietening down and unfortunately Margot has disappeared at this stage.
Yeah, so I did not see the quieting down. I did not hear the...
And light starts to creep into the area.
Mm-hmm.
And as light starts to creep into the area, the sound of goblins gets further and further away.
Mm-hmm.
As they hate the sun.
Because we were literally partying all night.
Yeah. It was basically midnight-ish when the combat started, and you fought for close to.
So are we now fatigued?
If you don't rest before going off and doing stuff, you'll be fatigued.
Yep.
I'm so resting. I need spells. I need my spells back.
So you haven't had a chance to rest yet because you've all been fighting one thing. And you.
I may have one left.
You find that the town didn't get through this. Particularly well, but it could have gone worse. The town didn't burn down.
Completely.
Citizens survived.
Thanks to Margo and
her diplomacy. Though they did have a high toll on their children.
Mm-hmm.
So a big chunk of the town's kids
mm-hmm.
were harmed in the thing. Some survived with burns.
Like by reports, were the goblins really targeting?
Goblins were targeting.
Or were the goblin? Or was it killing? Randomly dispersed, or were they actually deliberately targeting kids?
They were targeting whatever was
weakest. Right.
So there were a whole bunch of farm stock that were gutted.
Yep.
There was all the fields were burned.
So they're literally cherry picking.
Yeah. And basically, they were trying. The looks of things was they had tried to converge on the cathedral.
Yep.
And the fact that you guys put up a fight were and various other heroes wandering around through the town did.
Yeah, look forward to hearing, meeting them.
Yeah, yeah. So is everyone now gathering in that square?
A lot of people coming into the square.
The fires are out?
No.
Right, so you're organized to get the fucking fires out.
Mayor, what would you like us to do next?
The mayor is basically pointing people to fires and helping and bring the undead to the center. Because the last thing they want is an undead uprising.
Never fun. Well, I mean, always fine.
Is that an option?
Where's Val? We need an
undead uprising is always an option.
Really?
Especially without a priest.
Jesus Christ.
Damn it, Stefan.
Oh, so where did you grow up?
Sheltered child.
The mayor turns to you and says, where did you grow up, child? Obviously, you didn't grow up in
Jangerhof. What the hell is going on here?
We don't have stone to keep the dead in place.
My character doesn't help put the fires out. My character stands watch. Fuck that. Jesus.
He's looking at the pile of boys like, I think I see one.
Did it move? Stomp!
Please do not tell me that you're going around to all the dead bodies and breaking their legs.
No.
That would not be a good look.
I'm sure that's how I will live.
It moved. Smack.
Oh, you see like, some poor guy sleeping. Snap.
Well, ugly women tend to get their arms broken when they're around me.
Right, so you're going to be young and beautiful. We're narrowing it down.
If I took the karma process, I'd be running around with my sword chopping legs off.
Yeah.
So why are you sending on watch? You've got company.
No, I don't. She was taken away by Dad.
Well, the whole thing is everything's going.
She's got a higher stealth skill than her dad has.
You have.
So no, she's not there.
That was close.
And even her sister got caught.
What?
Oh, that's right.
Youngest sister, right?
Yeah.
What?
You'll find out.
No,
I'm not going to discuss that. No.
Sorry.
No, this is just getting worse.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, that's the line?
You saw that. She didn't look 13. Come on.
The next question is, there's a line?
Next question is, what did 13-year-olds look back then? Like, that looks like a 13-year-old.
No. Anyway.
Genetically gifted, some might say.
Well, they also had the thing of they have put in current morality into a lot of these books here.
Yeah.
So current morality is you're not an adult until you're 18 to 21.
Mm-hmm.
So anything that depicts as a child is below that.
Mm-hmm.
But when you look at the setting, the children pretty much become adults at the age of 14, 15.
Yeah.
So it does make the artwork not match.
Which is pretty medievally accurate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so you guys are approached by a elf who sort of looks like that.
Ooh. Has an interesting hairdo.
Okay. He does.
That looks very like.
Does the wind follow her around even though it's silver? Just rustles the cloak and hair.
Yeah.
Anime that style. Is definitely an atmosphere.
Pretty much wherever she walks. She does have this flowing on effect.
Yeah, Rangers, man, seriously.
Yeah, man.
That'll be you one day.
And she makes a beeline for Quest.
Hey.
Who is surrounded by friends,
and
right?
And studiously not paying attention to her.
And basically, as she comes towards you, she pulls out her...
whip?
Short sword, which starts to glow.
Chris casts shield.
Doozer also intercepts.
Yeah.
Doozer's gonna intercept while you do that.
Okay.
I wall of friendship. I'll be in that intercept.
Can we help you?
This will actually be an initiative.
There is definitely a mind.
What do you need to notice?
So it would be a perception roll.
And the notice to notice you need.
I'm on the stage. Perception. Yay!
Good luck.
This will be after you. This is during the cleanup activity, so anyone can be anywhere.
I'm assuming I'm not though.
No.
Can I sniff the blade?
Wait.
There is a glowing sword near Quest. He needs help. It's part of my goblin, you know, super ability.
I'm obviously far too focused on what I'm doing to roll initiative in any decent way.
Yeah. I'll just keep what I roll to notice, because that's perception.
Is this?
Perception. Okay, so what is Willy's perception?
15!
What is Doozar's?
21.
Nice.
What is Barry's?
Natural 20, so 26.
Bloody hell! Sweet. Hey.
And that's my 120 for the session. Bye.
15. And Margot's.
I figured I was too far away.
That's right, you're too far away.
Yeah. She's out of the city right now.
And Zed's.
I'm perception the shit out of these other goblins though.
Eight. Oh, sorry. No. Hang on. 9.
He accidentally poked.
Whoa! Right
Amazing.
Okay. So.
What's wrong, Rogue? You're not doing so.
I don't know.
So, Perry, you basically see her. She's just looking.
Is that too late?
I did not see anything.
Technically.
Sorry, we got distracted with talking.
You just see her looking directly at Quest and basically pulls out sword. Sword starts to glow and she's just walking straight at him.
Straight at him? Yep. Sword drawn?
Yep.
Tanglefoot.
Oh, you God. Cast a spell? Please, no. Please, no.
Great diplomacy skills.
You're going to catch all the
it's a 5-foot square. Yeah, person spell.
Yeah.
It's not entangled.
Yeah, it's not entangled.
Or grease. No. Mm. It's just on her. I'm just trying to slow her down. Mm. I'm just trying to her to stop. Just don't move for half a second.
Okay.
I just need to figure out.
I believe it's a reflex
save.
Good chance! Yeah, you've got a good chance!
Ooh.
You want the DC, no?
Let's try and find
it. Stick Google the eyes on it.
It's actually not.
I know, I was thinking it would look really good. It's actually a spell tank, but I'd stick googly eyes on the top.
Okay, in which case, then you roll.
Yes.
Damn.
It's a bit like some weird.
Because it was her role, you had a chance.
What did you get on the reflex save?
2.
You rolled a 2.
She rolled a 2. We don't know what the rest of it was.
Probably not. Probably would have been
12. Whatever it was going to be.
Roll a 16 and it should be fine. That's not a 16.
That's a. Probably actually will be 16 in total. No. 17 in total.
The hero dodges my
17 in total?
Yeah.
Okay, you miss.
Oofed. Oofed.
Third action.
Third action.
I'm assuming that was two.
Third action.
Oofed.
Yeah, I'll probably just miss Tanglefoot. I'm probably just going to say halt. Please don't do what I think you're going to do.
You're in 3 words. Okay. It's free. Halt. Please
No, it's...
He thinks, bye. He's using his action.
So, Doozar,
but you're screaming this out, right?
Yeah.
Cool.
I presume I hear him. I presume I see her as well. Yep. I get out my great axe and stand between her beeline for Quest. Essentially mirror what Parry is saying, just please do not kill our friend, he is not like the others.
Oh, why did you say
well
what about
is he
friends
really your
to
friend?
Technically we're related.
You're making friends with girls?
I think that makes perfect sense. Doozar is not our wordsmith. Okay. Totally
so,
valid statement.
You say that, what are you doing for the rest of your actions?
Tackle. Oh, it was a move. And so you got your great axe out.
Tackle.
Well,
I
also, you moved.
No, I have a quick draw, so that technically.
But you didn't strike, so technically it's still the action.
True. Okay.
Now you shot another attack.
You've got a free strike if you're gonna do it, but.
Killer!
No, I'm just gonna. Is there like a hold in action where.
You can spend 2
something?
Actions to do something, but you spend 2 actions to do
to
a 1 action thing.
Oh, okay, and I've already used 2.
So, yeah, so if you had two actions free, you could have spent two actions to do a single action event.
Mm.
But you can't do it to do more than a single action event.
Actually, I thought it was actually worse than that. I thought you have to spend two actions to then spend your third action.
Use up two actions. I'll double myself a reaction.
Either way, it takes two actions to do it.
Yeah, no, so I only, I don't have that.
What do you want to do with your last action?
I don't really want to attack her.
What's the quest of the time?
We're trying to stop her!
By saying, oh, please don't. Please don't kill the goblin. Okay, well, we asked
you. I try. Politely.
I try. I said, please don't.
I don't know. What would be a good option? I don't really have much to do apart from either attack her or leave it be. And see if she stops.
You could try grappling her.
You could.
I guess.
I give her a hug!
I guess yep. I try.
How does a bad grapple look to another person?
It looks like a grapple.
That's what it looks like.
You're not politicizing that in a way of saying, I'm sorry, I thought you were very attractive, and I thought you were very attractive.
Touch.
Yeah, I mean, you could possibly pass it off as an awkward hug that didn't get reciprocated. Yeah, I'm sorry, man. So, I mean, if you fail.
Really? Yeah, friendly grapple, not grapple.
Yeah. But if you don't grapple, you're like, oh, that was an awkward hug.
Went for the high five.
Go for a grapple.
Yeah. Went for a high five. Grappled your
grapple
arm.
Is.
I believe it's the
skill thing. Athletics
yes.
Versus their
fortitude
DC.
Mm-hmm.
So give
also,
me
by the way, you
athletics
should do
roll.
I shouldn't do it.
Yeah.
No, I mean, everyone else is probably keeps. I would do it.
Athletics roll.
Now I might want to re-roll up. It's an 8 plus 8 so 16.
Look, I think us proving our incompetence against the local town hero is probably as on brand as we could possibly be.
Yeah, okay.
Now you do the high five.
The hero walks through. Spell.
That's what the system is.
Grapple.
Yeah.
Whatever else were us going to do?
I'll do it. I'll do it.
No, it's not on your quest.
Oh my god. 18 plus 8. 26.
Oh, so you took the reroll?
Yes, I took
that's a great roll.
Yeah.
That's a great roll.
Well, I have plus 8 to my athletics, so.
It's awesome.
Just making sure I get all the numbers right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, basically just gonna like try and stop her from killing our friend.
There's definitely intent there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just a slight bit.
Some would say murderous.
Not really.
So what did you get on your thing?
26.
She's like, I'm here to kill goblins and chew gum. I'm all out of gum.
Luckily, you're out of goblins.
I got a goblin.
No, there's one there.
Yeah, I'm an orc.
You got a spare hat?
No, it's just a really hideous defamation.
Kind of got burnt a little bit.
Yeah, are you starting on it now?
Okay, so you successfully grappled her.
Nice!
Then it's her action.
Yep, shit. No, I figured that much.
Out she comes! Yeah. And still going for quest.
Yeah, no.
Now it's time for that 2.
You know that 2 you rolled?
Misrolled.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't think Tanglefoot was a reflex thing.
What are the effects? Is it like immobilized on a hit, or does it need
it's
a critical
immobilized,
success?
It's immobilized, she
looks down at you. She's tall.
Oh, that's right, she's a pure blood elf.
She's like 7 foot or something, isn't she?
Yeah.
Jeez. And she says you're lucky you're not a goblinoid. And basically slips right out of your hands as if nothing's there.
Yep.
Whoa.
Yep. Yep. I can't say anything in reaction.
I've got you.
As long as she stopped looking at our friend, I'm fine.
Yeah, quick success gets the target the immobilized condition.
And but a normal success is just slowed.
Yeah.
Like, oh, sorry, 10 foot.
10 minus 15 foot.
Okay, and then
So does she say anything more than that?
No, that's what she says to you.
Oh, come on.
She doesn't spend an action. That's her free action.
Yep.
And as a critical success, she actually gets a free 5-foot stride,
which she uses to step up to the goblin.
Yep. Oh, here we go.
And then tries to grab the goblin.
Oh, grab the goblin.
Apparently she rolled badly, so that means she
has your fortitude.
Okay, that's
no,
it's a lie.
Yeah. I'm sitting on.
I'm pretty sure Drew's is the only one that's got like the highest on fort in the party, apart from maybe Kiro.
But Martin, the dice isn't showing up on the screen, just FYI.
No, don't tell me you broke again.
Don't know. All I know is I look at there for the see the numbers.
Okay, so let's see if I fix that. I'll break other cameras, but it will work. If you don't tell me it's broken, I can't fix it.
I didn't notice. Well,
oh, because I can't see the dice, so I was looking at that. I'm like, oh.
Oh, because
where is the dice roll? There it is.
It's a vampire dice.
Yeah, I was like, what's going on?
And then I have to fix the other camera, otherwise you've got this unfortunate look of you.
Yeah,
there we go. See, look, camera working
again.
Yeah, cool. Okay, so she gets a... So get. I'm just basically converting on the fly. I believe she gets a 16 on her grapple.
Versus
your minus 5 and 11. I think.
Oh yeah, because escape is an attack.
Yeah, escape is an attack.
Sorry, versus fortitude.
Yeah. Versus 11's a
so it's 10 plus 4, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so miss.
Yes!
Thank goodness for minus 5. Thank goodness for minus 5.
Okay. Oh, it was a bit higher because you're her favourite enemy. So it was another 13.
Still miss.
Just.
Just.
Yeah, 4, 15.
Yes. And then she ends with the only goblin, only good goblin is a dead goblin. In response to your thing. Okay, so now it is Willie's turn or Quest's turn. Who would like to go first?
I'll let Quest go first.
Yeah. Bye. I'm sorry, you're mistaken. I'm a bard, not a goblin. Then he'll take an action to move backwards.
That's a straight line,
she. Oh, she has a reaction. Oh,
no. I'm going to take the step backwards.
Okay, just a single step?
No, it's a move.
Run now!
Okay. Well, there is a move that is a single step, and then there's a move that is...
Move action to get 25 feet away from her.
Okay.
Did she use Hunt Prey?
Not yet.
No. Then she can't do it.
She can't do it?
I'll check if she's with the ranger. Yeah, with the Oh,
she's crossfighter.
Okay, but did she actually... If you're a crossfighter, you still need to take the feat to get attack of opportunity. Mm-hmm. And if it's just the ranger one, you need to actually have Hunt Prey on, I'm pretty sure, to actually get the reaction with the feet. Disrupt Prey. There it is. Yeah, your Hunted Prey is within reach and uses the move action or leaves the square.
Okay.
That's your go.
And then I take an action to cast Shield.
Well, next time I might have to stop and stat out the whole character then. If you want to go that way and rules lie on me, we will stop the game while I create the character.
I apologise, but...
Because you did rule lie on me then.
I apologise. I was just double checking.
Okay.
So, where am I? Considering I wasn't part of the...
So, but we haven't finished the Goblin's turn. He had one action.
He cast shield.
And shield.
Yeah, so move, that's shield, shield, and
he spoke
speak.
To start with. He said too many words.
You can say more than that in a free.
Can I try and make a diplomacy roll here? Can we please just not fight and have a conversation instead?
Unfortunately, you can't do that in combat. But you can say that.
Yeah, I'm just going to say that.
Because influence someone is a is not a encounter exploration.
Yep.
Okay, so that brings us to Willy as you try to talk.
I take as many moves as I need to do to get to her.
Two.
I stand in, hopefully I'm in front of her. I take up my tiger stance.
And I basically say, move and die.
Nice. Correct. It's not. No, that's
the impetuous of youth.
And now it is Zed's go.
So it's not move or die.
As Zed is going to take
move and die. Move and die is pretty clear.
Do we know your quest?
Move, die.
Kind of.
Stay, move.
I've spoken about.
Well, she never said stay, live, move, die.
That's the assumed opposite. If you don't want to die, you don't move.
I can't be held responsible for what you assume.
Quest, it's up to you whether you resist or not. I'm not trying to actually do this too forcefully. But she is, Zed is literally walking up to you, grabbing around you, trying to give you full concealment with her cloak and full cover with her body.
Okay, I'm not going to fight her.
And then, like, with an action saying, please stop. We need to talk about this.
Well, yeah, our people wanted to climb us.
Not goblins. They're not actively killing children. Yes.
I haven't seen that.
Okay, just going to use the stuff block instead.
Really?
Okay.
That was fairly close to what I thought of. Okay, so it is...
Game Master guys got really good ones for those.
Yeah, this makes this Harry. Amazing.
With what he's said to the party and generalized, know that he's trying to help liberate goblins. I want to, in terms of saying, listen, yes, he is a goblin, but he's not the enemy. As you can tell because he speaks.
Who can speak?
He can read too.
Oh, he can read, right.
Look, he reads this sentence. Read it, goblin,
you
read it.
Spend your time explaining that. Do so.
I try and grapple her again, because she's probably going to try and move.
Again. Tackle from behind.
Scrum.
Give another go.
No.
What did you get?
A 3. That's gonna, probably going to be a crit fail if we roll that too.
No, you got plus 8?
Plus 8.
So 11.
11. Take out a tooth, hit the cement, you'll be fine.
No. You grab
okay,
your body.
Okay, so what happens when you crit fail?
Yeah, see? Yeah, I'll be fine!
No, you'll lose a tooth or two, you'll be fine.
You just attack with your dog instead.
Okay, so you fall flat on your face. as she basically just troops you.
Yeah,
oh, I didn't even lose a tooth. Good times.
Good smile. Move and die. Be good on my
but you've still got another action.
More actions.
I have
actually.
Two more actions. One of them made me stand up.
Okay, so you're down to one action.
Try it again.
Again.
Yeah, but I have minus 5.
Oh, it'd be so funny.
That'd be hilarious. Oh my god! Get up! Oh my god!
This time you'll chip a tooth.
Actually, you know what?
Again.
I'm gonna hump prey on her, because if she starts attacking him, we're gonna have problems. It's game on. Yeah, it's game on, so I'm gonna hump prey.
Okay.
She should know, like, that gets.
She turns and hunts prey on you.
Yep, that's.
Apparently,
fair.
You declared fighting words. It is not a...
Range it or range it.
Yeah, range it or range it.
I think one's a bit...
Okay.
One's a bit more buff than the other.
So she swings her short sword at you.
Yeah. Oh, new. Yeah, fair.
That's fair.
Okay, so she rolls badly. She hits armor class 22.
Oh.
Holy fuck.
It's a
hero. Local hero.
Local hero, yes.
Level
it's nice
10.
Knowing you, Bruno.
It's a hit, but it's not a crit, thank fucking god.
Here you go, half your hit points.
Yeah. Here you go, half my hit points.
Okay, so she does 12 points of damage.
Close to half your points, but anyway.
Yeah.
Nope, sorry. It was 15 points of damage.
Hello from the outside.
Holy
shit!
You're down
to 17.
And
can I have your
combo? She swings
when you
again.
Fuck's sake! My turn is yes.
Same.
Because it's on prey, I believe it means she gets
it's one less on the negative. Is it agile weapon?
Yep.
It's a minus four.
Minus four.
So it's just whatever her bonus is.
Yeah, if she's a particular ranger it's even better, but it's up to mine.
So that means it is a 20 or sorry, this is an 18 on the roll.
Which
the
is number. Which is still the number, so
ow.
Yeah, that's gonna hurt.
And that is 13 points.
Oh, you done four.
And that's her three actions because she hunt prey as well.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm totally still young, I know.
All right. Well, she's
you
not.
You found a better ranger.
I'm level
oh,
two.
Sorry, I forgot because oh, she hit you and the type of hunt prey. She
oh, you're going to be down.
It is 4 points on
yeah,
the
you're down.
First one and 5 points in the second.
Down.
Okay.
You're a good soldier.
Quest.
Good soldier.
Run.
Once.
Run.
Drop. Well, you're currently
we place held.
Stop and this do. And cast Sooth on Doozer. We really don't need to fight.
Well, sorry, what does Sooth do?
And is it a ranged? Is it a ranged spell?
Yes, it is a ranged spell. Cool.
Can't you fit all of them in one and just do
this? Is the equivalent of what she would have done to Father Xanthius if she wanted to.
All
cool.
Then another action.
Like I said, you were about to find out.
Zero.
That's
a 10.
That's 14 HP.
Thank you.
And for some duration, you get a plus 2 stat bonus to saves versus mental effects.
So you are on wounded one.
Yep. I know the drill.
Then, yeah, raise shield. Oh, I'm under your cloak, so I'll.
You decide to pick a fight with the bigger ranger. What happens?
She was listening!
She was
listening.
She chose
to only listened when I hunt prey.
No, she answered you.
Yeah. Gave you a response.
That's what
to
she
your
listens
words.
To.
Yes.
Up until you hunted prey, you weren't a threat.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Which is precisely why I did it.
I'm
why
so
do you think
glad.
I'm casting non-lethal spells? Okay. I don't want to be hit
Willy.
By this.
Hidooken! She technically didn't move.
Yeah, she didn't move.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, but she technically did smack
you. She did smack down your...
She moved. She didn't take a stab.
Yeah,
yeah,
I think
move.
That's a move.
It's a move. Oh, that's a
26?
One.
A 26 is a hit?
No critical.
No.
No, of course not.
You almost missed.
Oh,
roll well now. Roll really, really well.
She's not
well.
A level 1 character.
She's like level 4 or 5 probably.
10.
No.
Roll
10.
Really well.
10.
No. No, she's not above 10, but she is a high level character.
I think that might have been a critical miss, a 14.
A 14 is a critical miss.
Okay.
Was it a 1?
No.
No.
Well, the good news is you still hit the first time.
I'm going to...
what would you like to do if you miss?
I'm going to stumble and not get my third action. I think is my...
That is fair.
My thing. She is going to take...
That.
A massive.
Roll well.
7 points.
Not horrible.
And she needs to make a fort save. Or be stunned!
Stunned one, isn't it?
Depends.
Okay,
yes. Stunned
so.
Nothing. Don't worry, man. It's nothing. It's nothing. Nothing. Don't worry.
You mean you don't want me to
do
it?
Doesn't
she roll
matter.
A
25. No. Sorry.
She rolled a 25.
Ooh.
Yeah, doesn't matter.
No.
Oh, doesn't matter.
Did you even hurt her at all?
Yeah.
Did you though?
I did. I did 7 points.
Did you?
He bruised her, so now she knows he's there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You gave
my character
a
takes
bruising.
A back step as my free action. I go.
Wow, Tiger Sand.
This is a battle.
Yeah.
This
yeah.
is
a battle.
It's my character.
Days.
Come on,
Zed. You're watching your party get ripped apart.
Well, yeah, well, I'm not trying to attack her. I'm trying to be the voice of reason.
Oh, hi.
But it's not working in combat.
I'm not trying to attack her, I'm just trying to slow her down.
But, yeah, it's more along the lines of, we are not the enemy. The enemy is at your gates.
Or ran through the gates.
Yeah,
anyway.
I feel like that's going
to
be hard to sell now.
Okay, you say that. What does Perry do?
I just don't know what the trigger is to actually get through this girl.
So your hunt prey has dropped.
Has it?
Yes,
dropped?
Because
you
went
unconscious.
Down.
Oh, because I went down, yeah, right, okay.
But hers is still up on you.
That's right.
I don't think it...
Technically, because I came back up. because I got hit points.
You were still a valid target until you died.
Even unconscious, you're a valid target.
No, but it's still, for me, an hour, isn't it? On an active target, even if I go down? Because if I come back up, if I'll die...
Just, I'm pretty sure it's a concentrate.
It is a concentrate, but so, the way
you lose concentration when you're unconscious.
Okay, that's fine. I can easily hump break, and that's
fine. Yeah, it's just, it's that other action to come back up.
So, Josh. So this would have gone completely differently if we had have done the linear style to the...
Yeah. Hey.
I don't mind getting beaten to a pulp to save my friend. It's fine. Yeah. It's fine.
Yeah, it's
okay. It's just the way... I hate how it's worded. The way hump prey is worded is the worst ever.
I'll talk to you about it later because I actually really like it.
A lot of them are worded in the terms of programming language.
Yeah.
So it's very explicit how you read it if you understand code.
Very if and. Hey, Peter, can I ask a favor? Can I please grab a bottle of water and a glass from the fridge?
There's some in the front hatch.
I'm just
Tanglefoot again, maybe?
No.
There's the definition of insanity, and the definition of insanity.
We're insane, right? Yeah,
obviously, you're trying to save a goblin.
Sikes.
I'm just going to say, everybody stop when we negotiate, please.
Just call it the ending, man.
Thank you.
Okay.
And thank you.
Dooza, what does Dooza do?
Dooza stands back up again.
Don't. You just heard me. Don't.
Dooza puts his axe away.
Thank you.
And says, basically, nicely played.
Nicely played. GG guys, GG, well done.
GG.
Is that another smack? Another scar to the body.
Rack up another scar. Yeah, I'm just
like. Well, that's three actions, isn't it?
Yeah, okay. I'm just like, all right, let's pull.
Okay, so for her first action, she flicks the blood off the blade at you. Your own blood.
Yep.
Before sheathing it.
Yep.
And then she pulls out her bow and knocks an arrow as her final action. She spends basically one action flicking it at you, one action putting it away.
The good news is it'll go through me first.
Yep. Okay.
She's really adamant in getting this goblin, eh?
Yep.
It's her personal enemy.
I know.
Don't worry, the Tuesday group are about to face this soon. At higher level.
Great.
So that was her action?
That was her action. So it's now Questro.
What did she do?
She flicked the blade, sheathed her sword, and knocked an arrow.
Yeah, she flicked the blood at me deliberately. My own blood, mind you.
So what is she doing?
She's trying to tell you about
arrow pointed at him.
To use.
So I'm in front of him.
I'm not running. It's a longbow, isn't it?
First. You can barely see because you're hidden under my cloak, right?
It is like, a longbow.
You want to stick your head out and like lose that concealment?
And you can basically see the arrow light up.
As well. Mm. Wow. So like everything she owns is basically like detect goblin.
Yes.
That's
it's not
detect goblin. It's exclusive
round. But the sword lighting up
the sword seems to be goblinoid sting Tolkien based.
Yeah.
That's what it is. Bang of goblin. It was driving me crazy. I was like, Blue sword. It's a Lord of the Rings thingy.
Or Christ goblin bane.
Yeah. Or Christ goblin cleaver.
Yeah, you never see them light up blue.
No. That's no, you don't see them, only sting.
Yeah, in the book.
In the book, yeah, certainly.
And Glamdring, the foe hammer. Find the reference. So now
I'm going to spend two actions, two forbidding wards, giving myself a plus one AC versus her attacks. Raise my shield.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That one little point will make a difference.
We're hoping. Look, it's...
Well, it's between a critical and a non-critical.
Yeah.
Yes.
Save the day.
That'll make a difference.
Okay.
That's three actions.
Willy, you'll step back.
Have I?
Yeah, you did step back. You stepped back and said, come at me.
No, no, I didn't move. Oh. I just went.
But you signaled to come at
me. She seems to be ignoring you.
Again.
Oh well, it's a mistake. I make her really pay for it.
But she does have an arrow.
Do you?
Probably not. She got a longbow out.
Yeah, bruiser again on the other side.
You don't have my arrow.
But you don't have reactions, dude. So even if she shoots, you're not going to be able to hit her.
No, I'm going to fuck her up now.
Oh, okay.
You go for it. You go for it. Go on.
Probably not.
Go, Willy.
Wow. Woof. Until you fall.
Oh, Nobi!
What's the basketball thing?
Oh, Nobi.
Airball.
Can I take her longbow off her?
Sure, give it a try.
I looked up the rules after you did it to me.
Yeah.
You need a critical success.
Okay, yep. I don't do that. My character's going on how easy it was last time.
Yeah. I'm just warning you. Not only was I level one, but you actually need a critical success to disarm someone.
Am I getting any bonuses from...
No.
He's
not taking himself.
There's nothing inspiring being sung right now.
Literally told everyone not to fight.
Yeah.
Here he is going... There's someone trying to kill me, and I'm not going to inspire the people trying to defend me. What the hell?
Because the people who attack in defending are going down like 10 pins.
Go, Willy, go!
Yes.
Yep.
27.
Mm. Holy crap, that's a great roll.
Great
roll. No, you just hit.
Mm. Yep.
You suck.
I presume the critical is to be like
and a natural five. One.
What's lower than a critical failure?
Oh.
A critical failure with cards.
That's
it's a natural one when you also critically fail.
Yeah, that's a fatality.
So what is the total number there?
1 + 5
is definitely
six
a critical
is
failure.
Is a 6.
Is it even +5?
It is.
No, because it's -5 for the second attack.
No, -4, because it's an agile weapon.
Okay.
Was it part of a flurry?
Yes.
Then it doesn't get the penalty until after the flurry. No, the flurry both attacks happened at the same value.
No, that's not how I read it.
Oh, no, because flurry's both of them at -2, right?
No, they both happen and then the penalty applies in the next attack.
I didn't read it that way. I read it as...
That was the specialty of the flurry.
Yeah.
In the old way, I don't think that was here. I thought it was actually worse now.
Yeah, I didn't read it that way. I read it, you do your first attack.
I prefer your way.
And then second. Oh, I do
that is the intention behind it. I have actually been talking to the people.
But it says apply your multiple attack penalty to the strikes normally.
Yeah.
After it.
Yeah, no, it doesn't say after.
It's meant to be after.
Cool.
Yeah. Does it? Is it?
Cool. I like that.
That wasn't in the errata, though. I love that way better.
That's rules as intended, not rules as written. Rules as written is so much more restrictive.
So it's a 10.
So it's a 10. It's still a critical.
I mean, let's get it there.
But the thing is, if you haven't gotten high enough, it wouldn't have been a critical miss and just a actual non-carded one. So you're doing
still would have been a miss to a critical miss.
Yeah,
it would. It wouldn't have been a card critical miss.
Okay.
Because it's only if you critically miss on the dice before you get the one.
Okay. Yeah,
it's to make it a little easier.
Just before you really royally screw me over.
Yep.
It's 14 points.
Yep.
And she needs to make a fort save.
Of which.
How did you do so much damage?
Rolling.
Okay,
so you get striking or +1.
She rolls badly and gets an 18.
Oh, you suck.
At this rate,
she needs
to
fail the fort save.
Oh, you bought the striking ring.
Yeah.
She needs.
Okay, so with your critical fumble.
Yes.
You knock yourself out.
What?
You,
that's
first.
That's
you,
probably the safest
fall unconscious
thing to happen
until you
to
wake
you.
Up at or the end of your next turn.
Okay, can I change it a little bit? Can I have it that I've slashed her across the face, like really light wounds?
I'm feeling
points,
a little
14 points, but light wounds, you know, because she's probably got a heap of hit points. And as a reflex, she's smashed me in the face with the bow. And I've gone, I'm just
okay.
Just a story.
Rather than doing it to
yourself. Rather than going, that's what's up in the face.
But come on.
You punch her in the face. And she
Slash her.
Slash her in the face. You swacks you with the bow.
Yeah.
And you
was
go
that,
down.
Did you read bludgeoning on that? Because apparently it was slashing due to his...
Oh, no, it doesn't matter, does it?
Yeah, it does.
Oh, does it? Okay, well, mine's slashing.
Oh, actually, it was unarmed versus melee in range. Yeah. That was the unarmed one.
Yeah. Just different than attacks.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay, critically hit, he does it, has a different bonus.
Let's make
a job. And I do like that it has the unarmed version.
That's pretty cool.
Mm. Okay, so. And then it is no. Let's go as you watch her take out another one of your party members as a reaction.
As a that's right, yeah.
Please, seriously, we are here to help. Please calm down.
I didn't realise what Willy had a glass jaw.
Willy's a glass cannon.
Willy is quite short and sharp in a lot of methods.
Yes.
With Kenobi and a lot of other ways.
Hurry.
I'm not the only glass cannon in the group now. Yay!
You haven't gone down very often.
Yeah.
If at all.
Do you remember?
That was, of course, just the Countess.
No.
The first battle that we did.
Oh my goodness, like going through that fort. Man, seriously, every encounter. Oh, you're down again.
No, I just ran head first. I ran down once. But I ran head first into the
goblins.
Tank! Here we go, level 1. Level 1 wizard tank!
Why did I miss half of that again? I missed that Friday. Yeah, and I can't remember why.
It was hilarious.
Ice skating.
Yeah, ice skating.
Yeah, that would explain a lot.
So, what, it ticked 6 back?
It was Zed's go next. Was it?
I said Zed. Yep. Zed is literally just doing the whole keeping him covered, like literally giving him full body cover, full concealment.
I may as well cast Tangleflame, try and hopefully get immobilized out of this, but probably won't.
Get her to tell everyone to calm down, but okay.
I try, but people still want to punch each other.
And I think a lot of people said calm down. At some point, calm down means fuck you. You just
gonna keep on attacking because I've got actions left.
Yeah, you're just pissing me off now. I'm just gonna punch you because you tell me to keep fucking calming down.
Actually, no, wait. You've put your
axe away.
I've put my
axe. He's unconscious. Okay, no.
So no one is actually attacking. So
basically, if you throw anything, you're the
attacker. And she's gonna
I'm going to walk up in front of her, dressed with my staff, not just put it beside me, and I'm going to get in the way of her shot.
Okay.
And just say, please stop.
She does the Counter Strike lean.
pretty much
I have 3 shots, I can make
Doosa.
Pretty much Doosa's action is gonna be the same, just like making a wall in front of
that was the plan.
We're making a wall of friendship finally. With Willy fucking crumpled in a heap behind us.
Carry him to the wall! Just pick him up!
Alright, I pick him up!
Use him as a shield.
So apparently you've got really good friends.
Really, always saves us.
Not me, I'm just unconscious.
Surely, a common goblin wouldn't inspire so much loyalty.
He's a human shield for
Doosa,
but a human shield for you.
She has the bow ready, but she hasn't fired. She's sort of just looking at you all.
She's probably quite confused, I would imagine.
It's pretty hard to read her because she does have that look of...
what the fuck are all these people doing? Protecting your goblin? This is much. Confusing and strange.
Poker face, emotionless determination.
Pretty much.
Yep.
And you can sort of almost see the calculation of, can she take you all out?
Yep.
Yes. No doubt about that. I haven't healed
but
yet.
That's 5
hit
less
points.
Bodies to actually help the city.
Well, she seems to be having that query about should she or shouldn't she? As you see someone else walk up.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
Great. Other hero! Other hero that wants to kill
Goblin Quest. Chief!
Okay, so.
It's the Gropel Mayor.
That makes more sense.
The German word.
It's the elf's twin that also wants to kill Quest.
Yeah, while we were distracted with her, the assassins actually snuck up behind
you.
You
see a
oh look, the assassin
bard come wandering up.
Bard power.
She's pretty.
Really gonna go for that when he wakes up.
I don't know, she doesn't look young enough.
Here comes the seducer.
I thought we were friends.
Oh, well, she's clearly 18. I'm sorry.
Did you hear from the gates? She's not young enough.
And she says to the elf, so Shaylu, what you doing?
In her sort of cute 18, but to you, very old voice.
He also just, you know, looks at her in annoyance. Goblin. Yes. And? Goblin. And? Goblin.
It's
2 minutes later.
Actually, I'm stuck in an Abbott and Costello routine.
Yeah. Who's on first?
Goblin's on first. What's on second? Who's on third?
And she points at them and says, look, they've obviously caught the goblins, so you can move along and find any more stray goblins.
Oh, shit. Yay!
And she sort of looks at you guys with annoyance and I'll kill it later then. And she walks off.
Oh, thank God.
Well, you got an enemy.
With one of those steam off sort of things. You think basically you're more than happy to kill him anytime she comes across him.
No so matter is that who's like in the room. A time element gameplay or we just had to get close
you
enough to
are
death?
A target for one sick ranger.
So, what triggered the sister don't come just back making it all go away?
until she chooses to use it somewhere else,
no, that's why I'm clarifying now. Because
she's still concentrating.
Yep, great, because if...
You threw fighting words. Threw fighting words.
No, but the problem is, if she still has that ult, I think it's for like the next hour, she knows where I am.
Yep.
So...
That don't be a request.
Does she actually know, or does she just get bonuses to find
you? She gets bonuses to track.
She gets bonuses to track.
Yeah,
at her level, it's like...
At her level, she knows where you are.
Yeah, at her level, she knows where I am. So,
and you sort of have some idea of why she was leaping over buildings. And
at her level, she's already like... 100 feet ahead of you, just waiting, like, oh yeah, there. I knew they would come this way.
As I walk around this corner.
So she turns to Parry and goes, so obviously you're the front man here.
She saw what you did.
Yes.
Not the straight guy, but the front man.
Listen, my reputation precedes me, thank you.
And then she says, who are you?
Much better than Free Willy you're holding on.
How do they know my name?
Everybody knows your name. The 13-year-old was yelling it in the street.
Actually, that's probably true.
She was.
And then Jenny Willy! Jenny Willy!
No, she said, give me Willy!
Big Willy!
So, if I was to take your pet goblin away from Shailu, she has a hatred of goblins and has vowed to kill every goblin on site.
Yeah, we noticed.
Hi.
Thank you.
She will not deal with anyone who deals with goblins.
I respect where she is coming from, and I'll explain to her what Quest is trying to do.
Try not to explain it to her, she will treat you as a goblin.
Not to her, but we're talking
about
the bar.
No, as in to the bar.
Yeah. No, we're not trying
there's
to
no
yell out.
No point talking to...
No, seriously!
There's no point talking to the volcano that's just stormed off, okay?
That's okay, she's off to kill more goblins.
Does that include
goblins?
Yes.
Goblins and bugbears.
Just wanted to check.
She's got a bugbear?
She's killed quite a few. She's the reason why goblins want to attack this town.
Oh!
She's been killing them for over 100 years.
Also, if we kill her, we solve all our problems.
Partly.
I'm so glad you're not
why
here.
Why do you
say that?
Yeah, you're not even here!
So, my name is Amiko, and I run the local tavern, the Rusty Dragon.
And that was the sister.
Amiko?
Right?
But you probably already
Amiko?
Know that.
Amiko.
Amiko.
Amiko. And what was her friend's name?
Shailu. Shailu Andesano.
And is she human? Or is she
Amiko is human.
Yep.
Tien by the scent, by the look of her.
Do I know of her?
She is fairly well known as basically an adventurer retired running a tavern.
Right. Love your work! Shut up!
I have nothing against goblins.
Yeah. Hmm? Yeah. The volcano does.
Not a goblin. Thank you. We're all very much the same. We like nothing against them personally, but if they attack us, that's the problem.
Yeah. Yeah, I've killed my share of goblins. For Shailu, there's no problem with that happening.
I think we're going to kill that share of goblins.
Why does she hate goblins so fiercely?
Well, they killed her parents and tortured her when she was a child.
That's fair.
That's fair.
Yeah. Little racist, but fair.
And she has absolutely no sight where it comes to goblins. They're all evil as far as she's concerned.
Yep.
And
she
wants to eradicate the
world with race.
She's starting with this region.
Now. We have our virtues.
That doesn't seem to be going too well.
Out the planet
and she wiped out
the
hobgoblin tribe that was in the area.
We're recycling.
Then
joy.
Well, there are no hobgoblins left.
Thank goodness you didn't hear that.
And so why have we now got the goblin problem? Because there's no hobgoblins left?
Partly.
Is this like a circle of life nature chain that has been disrupted?
Yeah, probably.
The hobgoblins were the heart of the larger predators that were keeping the goblins at bay.
They did keep them in check.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now there's no one keeping them in check except for her.
This is like that whole sparrows locusts thing that happened in China.
Yeah.
And here am I trying to go and take care of the goblins, and I was like, ooh.
Yeah. How you take care? How you take care of the goblins may take a while to do the whole army.
I know. I find it pretty dumb. I mean.
As long as she does the leaders,
a little a little bit of child death along the way of corralling the leaders, it all works out.
So I guess the question is, what can we do to help
the goblins?
No, so you're not here. What are you?
Oh, I'm just asking.
We're just passing through, but I'm sure we'd all like to help, and we'd all like to get out of this alive. So what can we do to help?
Bringing the bodies to the clearing out any goblins that are left over, because they always leave some behind.
Yep.
Shaylu always leaves
some.
I'm out of first.
We can see.
Nah, damn it.
Which, full props to her. Just, we need to find a way to mark.
I know, you're using like unconscious condition, don't you?
She still has no definition of that.
Is there any place in the town that would be safe as a sanctuary from her? Like the church, your tavern? Is there some place where he won't be killed on sight?
Possibly the tavern. Possibly the church. I have not actually seen her stop before. This is the first time I've actually seen her stop.
Well, well done to you. Kudos.
Well, it wasn't due to me. I think she was calculating just how to kill everyone.
That's
that's a perfectly valid plan. Arrow in the back in the next hour.
She's doing this. Don't be surprised if that happens.
Yeah, dude's just like, I'm
really missed Stefan already. We're gonna need a lot of healing.
It's gonna go try and treat wounds on unconscious monk.
Yeah, oh, he's awake now. She was only down for a round.
Right.
The unconsciousness.
Unconsciousness was for a round.
Was really?
Oh, really?
You wake up being carried by Dusa.
You wake up getting held up in the air.
Okay, yes. Where's the bitch? What's going on? What the hell?
Calm down, this lovely young bard. Not that young.
Too old for you.
You're not there, sorry.
Yes, I know your reputation, Willie. Keep it in the pants.
Who the hell are you? I'm licking my fingers. The blood from the elf. I'm licking the fingers.
Oh, that's so creepy.
I'm the tavern owner who's going to ban you.
And vomit in your face.
Oh, yeah. Do what you got
to
do.
Wait, you said the tavern's a good place to go hide?
Yes, except for him. He's creepy.
Agreed.
You're not wrong.
Where's your friend?
I'm not going to tell you. Because we'd like you not to die.
Well, me and her got to have a conversation.
Then
you're going to die.
A very short conversation.
Possibly.
And the town needs the bandages more than you do.
Yep.
Oh no, there will be no bandages if he has a conversation.
Oh.
He'll be digging a hole.
There will be no. As Duzer was almost cut in half.
Yeah, she showed restraint. I know.
Absolutely admire your.
I think she made mention of me not being a goblinoid, and I should be thankful for that.
Oh, I do.
Normally, if she takes you down, she'll then stab multiple times to make sure you don't get back up again.
Yeah, it's written in the notes.
Yeah, fair. But I did hump fire on her, and then she humped her, and then I kind of fell over after that.
Or you just keep attacking until you're gone. Revenge. That's the usual method.
Right.
Yes.
She's hunted goblins for months just to take out that single goblin.
I might need to ask her about the one that got away from me this afternoon, then.
Revenge against this slide.
We could be friends, yes.
That's the only question you need to ask yourself.
No, I mean, did you actually impregnate 13-year-old? Because your odds of procreation are probably fine, so your line will live on.
You're not there, I got it.
Who's saying this?
That was that.
I assume that.
Who's this Jiminy Cricket grasshopper conscience that's giving me this bread at once?
What the hell is that?
I would say out of game, your odds of living on in some way, shape, or form. So,
I would
say if you actually did it with her.
That's the question. In terms of revenge, is revenge against that level of slight worth your life? That's the question that you can answer. It doesn't need to be now, but that's the question for you.
But again, conversations need to be had.
Okay. So, As you're pausing for a moment there, having a conversation with her, we now zoom outside.
There now, eagle flies over.
And you see that there is this horde of goblins moving
We're about to hit to a cutscene with just me and no supervision.
Yep. Yes!
So, you are amongst...
No supervision at all.
You are amongst a horde of hundreds and hundreds of goblins.
This will go well.
You're not about to die.
I'll die, or I'll murder to make sure everyone else in the city dies, by the sounds of it. But anyway.
You can see a couple of them are dragging along horse legs, or dog heads, or arms and legs from various people.
I'm keen for horse leg. People, they're a bit gamey.
And most of them seem to, grin at you. Lots of fun.
Hobgoblin not being killed by goblins? That's a good start. That's a good start.
Well, you look like a goblin as far as they're concerned, because you're short.
I can work with that.
You may be a weird-looking goblin, but all goblins are weird.
Yep.
Cool. What do you... gnome?
Hobgoblin gnome.
You run into a fence and die.
Great. So is the one I was originally following that you want to kill, have I still lost him in the crowd? Like, am I just wandering still for funds?
Perception roll.
Because I know I lost him beforehand, but I'm assuming I'm either gonna have to start following someone or following the basic horde. I did not see him.
Okay, so you do see that the goblins are splitting off into six different directions.
Six.
They achieve what they're supposed to achieve. Here.
Is the food going in a specific direction?
Each of them are taking chunks of food with them. So food's going in all different directions.
I'll follow the biggest / horsiest group.
Okay, so...
they're going to be the most
fancy. Is the group heading to the south?
Sure.
And they seem to be singing a song about lick toads.
I don't think I was a lick toad person. That's cool. I can pretend to be. And if they're singing a song about eating them, that's okay too.
That seems to be their war song about swamps, licking, toads.
Can I maybe pull one aside and ask for directions?
But they all stop and look at you. You've basically got about 50 of them around you all now looking at you. As the rest of them have moved on.
Horse, yay! And I keep walking.
They still look at you. Horse?
So I start singing lick toad.
You like horse?
I'm just continue. Yeah. I'm going to continue singing the lick toad song. Let's get some horse.
Give me a performance roll.
No. Oh, I can do that! No, I can do that!
I can do that!
A skill I actually have.
Oh, God.
As soon as you said directions, everyone's just like, hold on, you're too smart.
Yeah, I thought it might be a bit of a push. I thought they might point me in
the... Anyone have a GPS, you know?
What
are
the map?
King, leader, man.
I think that's wrong.
What's the goblins in the D&D game, and they might.
Ten.
They look at you, and you see the eyes all turn into little thin slits as they all reach for their weapons.
Here we go.
How do goblins feel about mine?
Mine.
They hang you over a pit.
Can I like
on the word.
Mime away?
Learn more words.
Come on.
And you hear one of them say, "She smells of gnome."
That's because I just ate one. Surely.
Uh-oh.
Making
she smells of human.
Uh-oh. You be...
Fuck you guys!
You smell of orc.
Gain one... Make an impression with performance. Do I
Shino
have a
goblin.
Minute?
They have start chanting Shino Goblin.
Uh-oh. You better get out of there.
Grab one and smack
him
about.
Is that gonna... There was like, what, 50?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm not gonna beat
up 50. Just find the biggest one and knock him about.
This is the way you say, nice knowing you guys and gals, I am going that way. Back to city.
Screw you guys, I'm going home.
Hang on.
Why can't I? Where's my intimidation? I can't see it on this thing.
Because it's up here where it says skills.
Mm.
And it's plus 7.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Can I attempt to intimidate them into being, I am scary goblin that smell like these things because I've just eaten everything?
You can.
Or something along
eaten
those lines?
Every-
I have eaten orc and human and gnome and every other smell that they can smell. Because I'm probably smelling dog too at this point, I'm imagining.
I tried myself in the blood of my
people. Yes, you do smell like puppy as well.
Mm. Yes, you smell like dog, which is their like favourite enemy.
Yeah, I said horse. But I meant eat to eat, not yay horse.
Give me
horse
your intimidate roll.
12 plus 7, 19?
Versus their will.
Versus their will?
Yeah. I don't know how to
do it. Let me have an
intimidation. Okay.
I don't
even know where to look that up.
DC. And this intimidation, where you demoralize is an action. Coerce takes time. Versus their will DC.
Will DC? Okay, they all take a step back.
Yes!
What did you actually say? They basically pull their weapons out.
Oh, God damn it!
Well, you're basically going, I'm a tough!
Yeah, let's...
And I eat humans, and I eat dogs, and I eat...
So, let's go back and eat some horse and have some fun.
You see a opening appear behind them as they're leaving space for you to head back to town, if that's what you want to do.
I would. I would.
I...
You hear the sound of sharpening of their,
How many actions
swords.
Do I elect to?
Well, you're not in combat at the moment, but they are...
No, that's okay, but if I use one or two actions...
That's not actions.
I say, hey, I think I saw some extra horse in town. I'm going to go get some extra horse and bring it back to you guys. Yay, more horse meat. And,
yay me!
And walk out towards the town.
Okay.
To go get more horse.
Okay. They all seem to eye you for quite some distance before they rush off.
But I didn't die, so it's okay.
That's a win.
Woo! I won!
Whereas if you had struck one of them, it would have been
one out of six paths, I got five more to try.
And yet you still have yet to hit anything.
And it's still survived. How many
I want you to play a fighter during this entire campaign and not hit a single thing. Let's do it.
So far it's working out pretty well.
Okay, give me a perception roll as you head back to town.
Uh-oh.
Elf.
Yep. Seems legit. 16 plus 8. 24.
Okay, you see the looks of an archer walking across one of the walls, shadowing you, watching you.
Cool, I head towards one of the other gnome groups. Quickly.
Gnome
groups? Goblin groups.
The other goblin groups are out of your sight.
Yeah, they've all run away.
You'd have to do a tracking to try to follow them. And apparently you're a goblin on their own.
Well, I'm Fox, nice to meet you. Okay, I don't think I can win here, so I continue on my way, trying to unsuccessfully hide or dodge.
Give me a hide roll then.
So has anyone found Margot's body yet?
I think, I have gladiator lore. Can I, like, outmaneuver her gladiatorially? That seems unlikely. Cool, so a hide roll, is that a stealth, which I don't think I have?
You did not pick up stealth.
No, I don't have stealth.
You're not particularly stealthy though.
No, I'm not stealthy. I am loud and
proud. Are you
proud.
Wearing your chainmail?
Yes.
Doesn't chainmail have the noisiest
attribute?
Mine is true to the roll as well.
This day is not ending well for Margot.
I mean, it's a bit of a judgment call, but we could probably say that was a zero.
Hang on. Sorry. What's your dexterity? No dexterity. It's a 3.
Yeah. Oh, is that the noise?
Yes.
Oh, it was a 3, not a 0.
Okay, so you critically fumble that one.
Ooh.
So the elf's like...
And, yeah.
Now I'm the horse.
The elf's gone.
Yay.
Apparently you've outsmarted the elf. You can't see her anywhere.
I am such a clever clogs.
You intimidated a bunch of goblins, and now you've outmaneuvered an elf. Winning! Winning!
I cannot wait to come back and tell you guys how awesome I am! Diplomacize the fuck out of this fucking event.
This elf and me are going to have so many goblins.
Okay.
You didn't die.
No, not yet.
So what is your passive perception? So it's 10 plus your perception.
That would be 17 then?
Try again.
That's
18.
My perception. Oh, 18.
Okay.
Dark vision, if it helps.
Yeah.
Not really. Not when you critically fumble the... you really succeed.
But it seems like it's a dark
vision. Okay, so... first thing you feel are two thin arms wrap around your neck.
Oh, at least they're thin.
okay, so what's your armor class?
18.
Okay.
Is this a thing?
Yeah, I think so.
So, next thing you know is you were grappled.
Not quite dead yet. Okay.
Quite successfully pinned. Critical success on the grapple.
Yep.
Yep. And a something that someone's punching you at the same time.
Would now be a bad time to sing. You can leave my hat on.
Possibly.
Turn into a gnome, maybe.
Okay, so apparently she's trying to capture you by beating you unconscious.
Well, then I wouldn't need my hat, so silver lining. But yeah, okay, being beaten unconscious.
Basically, and then that's the last you remember.
Yeah, okay. I'm pretty sure there was nothing I could say that I think at the time would help, except for, can you please put my hat on? Which I'm assuming was fuck no response.
With more of a...
And also, the fact is, I don't think she's going to fall for it either. Goblin, gnome, goblin, gnome, goblin, no. Yeah, it still wasn't going to work. I just don't want to lose the hat process, you know? So, yeah, no, I'm unconscious, being beaten to death by an elf. Makes sense.
Not to death, to unconsciousness. She can't question dead bodies.
Give it time.
She doesn't have that skill.
Give it time.
Not yet.
Well, high level ranger.
Yeah. Speak with the dead requires certain skills.
Yeah. I'm sure a centuries old ranger will determine that education at some stage.
Well, look at it this way. If she could get word, you know, information from the dead, she would basically be killing the goblins first and then questioning
them. And then question them later. This is the one that looks important. I'll question them.
Well, which is basically what she was going to do to you. She wasn't actually going to kill you. She was going to basically beat you unconscious and then question you later.
I'm sure Margo will have interesting things to say.
Well, the stupid thing is, she could just ask the questions now and we'd answer them. Instead, she's got the worst person to ask.
Okay.
I'll give nothing but movie lines. Just
so true.
Oh, so,
you gotta handle the truth.
Back into town.
Yes.
In
the box.
You see a guy dressed like this.
Oh, see now, he looks all proper and fancy.
He's quite fancily dressed.
Yeah.
He comes over to you guys, especially to Zed.
No, it's not the Gripple Mare, is it?
No, it's not the Gripple Mare.
Oh, just checking.
It is a top.
A toff.
Yeah,
fair enough.
He basically comes up going, well, nice to see you all. So glad that you managed to save us. Mm-hmm. He's one of the people you got into the cathedral.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You didn't really pay any attention to him because he was the helpless sort.
He was one of the helpless cowards. Zed gives him a curtsy.
Oh, such a pretty thing.
Charmed, I'm sure.
That I am.
Quest spells.
Mm-hmm. Oh, what a polite little goblin.
Kill a goblin.
You only kill goblins? Why do you only kill goblins?
I was joking out of character, but anyway.
Okay.
glad to see you survived, Mr.
My name is Mr. Foxglove, or you can call me Aldern, just for you, miss.
Oh, here we go. Another sleaze bag.
Aldern,
did
you say? Aldern. At your service.
I'm pleased to hear that. Very.
The service or
wasn't
the
very
was?
Serviceable when we were fighting, though, was he?
Well, you had a knife in hand, and I didn't have my weapons handy. They were in my room, not expecting them for the festival.
It was so nice that you managed to bring your weapons to the festival and save people. Mm. I would have done so myself, but I couldn't get to my stuff.
Completely understandable.
It happens. Yeah. Being caught unawares happens to the best of us.
And who wants to run through the streets without armor and weapons? That's just crazy. No. Not everyone's a monk.
No.
And and fights things with your feet. Just, crazy fighting with your feet. It must hurt a lot. Do you actually walk on coals to puffing your feet up, and you punch rock like they say in those stories?
I tend to take my fingers and I ram them into eye sockets and I pull pieces of people's faces off. Or I ram my hand into people's chests and I pull out their still beating heart.
Well, we've got some dead bodies over here. Can you give me some examples?
No.
No. It just sounds so interesting.
I'm sure it does.
I would love to write about it.
I'm sure you would.
I'm a writer.
The problem I'm sure you are.
The problem is their dead bodies, the hearts that I'm still beating.
But at least gives me an example to work with.
They can be quick enough.
Are you volunteering to be his living body to test it on?
No.
I didn't think so.
Not today, Mr. Fox. Well, Alden. No, not today.
Alden to you, miss.
So, it's wonderful to make your acquaintance. Do you have any additional servants or assistants who can help us with moving the dead bodies and clearing up the city?
Sure, I will get my butler. I was on my way there.
I'm sure.
Yeah, you dealt with most of the rebel in the street for me.
Indeed. You did mention at our service.
Yes.
Do you have lodgings in the town?
I do.
Would we be able to impose upon these
of
lodgings?
Of course you can impose on these lodgings.
Especially, it's hard to find. I believe our inn has actually burned to the ground. Mm. So we're all going to require...
Well, the Rusty Dragon also has rooms.
Oh, of really? Course.
It does.
So did poor Amiko's...
No. I'm just trying to find extra safe sanctuaries for him.
But did
did
Amiko's burn to the ground?
No.
Damn. I mean, that's good.
That's good. We in no way want to impose, but we do. I would certainly appreciate being able to take.
Sure, bring him along. Let's go see how the goblin will fit.
Indeed.
And I'm sure I've got a servant room for him.
And I'm sure your word carries some weight in this town. A man who finds such standing as yourself.
I'm an important person. You should all know me by now.
Wonderful.
However,
we do.
We do.
We do now.
if you could do your absolute best, I'd consider it a personal favour.
Yeah,
if you could help us ensure that our reputation as having a goblin on the inside to teach us how they think and help us defend the town would go a great way.
Well, that sounds fantastic. I'm sure you can get some more from that, bloodthirsty ranger. She always captures them and tortures them for days on end before she kills them.
Oh, cool. I have a couple of days.
Of torture.
We've noticed that Margot's missing at this stage, right?
Well, yeah, when you say missing,
we noticed Margot ran off
with the goblin.
Yeah.
Why would you think that?
But I'm pretty sure Dooza said... But Margo was chasing it down and hasn't shown up since.
If you could intercede on the town's behalf and stop the screaming, it sort of disturbs my sleep.
Yeah, so what was Dooza's interpretation?
I totally understand. A good night's sleep
that
is very important. Wonder well being.
You don't look this good if you don't sleep.
Right, so it's just...
Totally
been missing since.
I assure you, resolving the town's goblin concerns
deep in Dooza.
Is very high on our priority list.
So have your valet follow, and we shall find him a room.
Well, not right now, because we're all busy actively cleaning up at the moment, but we will take you up on that offer at a later time.
Okay, he gives you directions to where you can find him.
Wonderful.
And he says, and if he's not there, you'll find him at the Rusty Dragon having a drink.
We look forward to joining you when we have a chance to take a breath.
And he pats the goblin on top of the head. That's a nice goblin. That's a nice goblin.
No, that's not good luck, right? It doesn't work that way.
I'm not a dwarf.
He looks at you. Your servant speaks.
He reads too.
He looks at you.
He's singing well to it.
Can I have a song? Witch.
Look, I'll follow you around for a bit later and I'll see if I can whip something up for you.
Just as long as you don't whip it out like that Willy guy does. Turn your reputation.
Oh, no! Me too!
This song writes itself.
Whip it out, Willy!
No, it's simple.
I'm gonna end this town. I hate you all.
There's a song already for it.
Hang on, I'd like to point out. I physically dragged you away.
Yeah.
And you hunted her back down.
I never did.
You did in the fight. You hunted her back down. I shall save you, sweet little thing.
I never said that.
No, with your actions you did.
Oh, did I? Yes. Read into it much.
But as he walks away, Zed quite clearly talks to the group and says,
I'm going to hurt that guy.
I understand, but right now, why have enemies when you can have friends?
Because enemies make life more fun.
Or even better, frenemies.
Yeah. We have no organizational support in this town.
Do we need it?
Probably. If we're going to get out alive and work with these people to do so, quite possibly. I don't know how many armies of goblins we can take. Because have we seen them all like dispersing, or were we still like seeing the town somewhat surrounded by goblins? And
well, you'd heard that they'd been spreading further and further away.
Yep, for the day, but there's no guarantee they won't just come back tonight. So
I'm pretty sneaky.
Yeah, okay. That's good for you. Are we going to just sneak away, or I'm asking, and look, this is a weird group thing, but right now let's at least help clean up.
Yes.
And if the decision is later to sneak away separately, then let's discuss that too. But right now,
okay. And I still need to have my chat with Shayla.
Okay. So, at which point, Sheriff Hemlock shows up.
Great.
It's a very unfortunate name for a good guy. My name's Mr. Poison.
Yep.
It's
Sheriff Poison.
Sheriff Poison.
It is okay. Sheriff
Poison. Go sick.
Sheriff Hemlock.
My name is Sheriff
Poison.
I just want to see if I have a picture of him for you or her.
I am not sure it's him. Sheriff Diddley, not Shane. What?
I'm the good guy.
Oh, the good guy.
Tomato.
Black hat on.
What? Yeah, this is my deputy, Black Widow.
yes. Kill him on sight quickly.
My jailer, Rattlesnake Jim.
Have you seen the judge?
In the back, Frank.
Okay, it is.
Have you seen the judge? It's Judge Blackstone.
Balor Hemlock.
Balor Hemlock?
Yep, Balor Hemlock.
Okay.
Okay, so.
Or while we're like piling bodies and attending to wounded.
It says, hey you, you're good with your hands, aren't you?
Do not even think of going any further with that statement. I am so close to snapping my biscuit. I'm gonna hurt
biscuit?
People.
Oh,
well, I've got a problem that is right up your alley.
Ooh. Be very careful. I say, what? What's the problem?
Well, the goblins, I think, have raised some undead, so I thought you're the best person to beat the crap out of something. You just have this look of wanting to beat something up.
It's not wrong.
Yeah.
and I'm basically hunting hotheads. Do you have any other hotheads you'd like to bring along?
Doozer. Well, the wizard's pretty tanky. You look I'd take him into a fight. Take him into a fight. Oh, you've no idea.
We pointed to the scorch mark.
He's hardcore.
The pile of ashes.
Yeah,
all right, my character
the
says,
the
I'm happy to help. I need to burn off some aggression.
No one else hit me. He hit me.
How many hit points do you have right now?
I took no damage at all.
Oh, you took no damage. You just got like instant knockout.
Actually, I did. I took.
So I love about it. Absolutely no damage.
I think I took like 7 points from the last game, something like that. I got. Mm-hmm. I got an arrow.
Yeah,
it's
that's
a knockout.
It's the name.
It's a knockout.
Okay, so yes, he says, grab your people and come.
Who wants to kill some undead?
Oh, we also need to stop by and see if Shailu has hung up any more goblins.
I mean, you don't have to. Me and her are going to have some words.
Let's do that.
Actually, no.
Let's do that.
Let's go. Hopefully there's a hobgoblin somewhere in there. Okay.
No. Shailu first. Because we have to find out whether they've hung up any goblins.
Wherever Sheriff takes us first.
Where is she?
I have no idea where she is. She's always wandering around.
I asked the sheriff what is most important to you.
Well, if people hear the goblin screaming, they will be very much unable to reason with.
Does anyone have a health potion?
Which is the most threatening at this
stage?
Oh,
wait, we all got health potions.
The undead?
Yeah, and we all bought at least one.
Probably the crazy elf.
For 1d8 hit points.
Yeah, All right, we'll go to the we'll go see this crazy elf again.
Okay, so she he leads you down the street near the cathedral. And you can see that there are five goblins hanging by their feet, one of them being Margot.
Oh, great.
all of them seem to be...
Are they conscious?
Oh, no. Hey, guys.
I point at Margot. That's my thing!
I walk up to Margot with a water skin of water, and I'll splash it in the face to wake her up.
Okay, you've had water up your nose.
What the fuck, dude? You're trying to kill me?
I'm not trying to kill her. Should I save you again? That'll be fresh.
I don't know, I think you just poisoned me with this weird, clean smell. It's now drowning me.
Do you want me to save you for a second time?
I mean, is this saving me now?
Don't have to.
It feels like
I walk
poison.
Away. I look for the elf.
Oh, she's probably getting more things to question.
Cool.
She's our busy lady.
So if she comes back and finds that these guys have disappeared.
Just one of them.
How would you like them to disappear? Sword through the chest?
No.
Decapitation?
No.
That one's ours. It's another mascot.
Yes. Wait, are you with us?
Yeah, left you.
Yeah, I'm going to go
for a change. We're actually all together. All of us.
I thought you were safe in the inn. I'll take up the tiger style.
Tiger stash. Cut the rope.
Yep. And bink, she lands on her head.
Sheriff,
do with that.
If I could ask, we're happy to help, but we do have two of our number who are exceptional goblinoids and actually are on the side of civilization. They read, they write, they talk. How can
he
we...
He sort of looks at you with that incredulous look of, no shit.
Yeah, serious shit. So, we would appreciate your support in not letting them get killed when Shaylee comes back, because I totally understand where she's coming from, but they're of more use to the town alive.
I will try, but she's crazy.
I understand. Best effort is all I'm asking for. Like, there's no guarantees in life, but we'd appreciate your support.
I will try. Hopefully I fare much better than the last, I'm sheriff.
Hemlock is an actual self-inducing term.
What happened to the last sheriff?
He was killed in an alley.
No, let me guess.
Sheriff Stabby Which Stab one? Died quickly.
By a citizen.
Yeah.
Just by a random citizen.
He points to some of the buildings. You can see that there's some carved birds on them. The guy who carved all those.
Is this a recent
problem? Guy or a person?
A few years ago.
Oh, so not like last week or anything.
Not like last week.
How was he killed?
So, are we next in line?
Rather
mystery.
With knives and had his eyes plucked out, just like he described. Except they also took the tongue as well.
Oh, wow. Interesting. Maybe so probably not the end.
So probably a follower of your belief system.
Well,
I admire
his restraint.
So you worship the god of demons, apparently, because that's what they do.
Is it why that rover guard conversation comes back to bite you?
Why do you think that?
Because he was worshipping at a devil shrine, having ripped his own eyes and tongue out.
That seems a little
before killing himself.
That seems a little bit strange. What the hell would you do?
The last conversation we had on religion, you were telling the cleric of Pharasma how much you respected rover guard.
I do. I don't follow, but I do respect.
Okay, let's just keep that one on a down low. Low, 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 low.
Like, keep that under the soles of your shoes, bro.
Anyone who doesn't respect that level of power is a fool.
Anyone who says how much they respect that level of power openly is a fool.
I don't think so.
Boots with the fur.
So, are you a follower of Lvl2, the mother of demons?
I'm not a follower of any god. They're not worth following.
Such venom.
Ooh, spicy.
Was it cheaper?
In that case then, I'm more than happy to vouch for your goblin. Which one's yours again? They all look the same.
The one that's still lying with her head in the mud.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
We need to get you guys like is there a band or sign of the town, like local militia or something like that?
Is your sheriff?
Unfortunately, yes.
Okay. Would it be possible to give those two honorary ones just to mark them as do not shoot on sight?
He sort of sits there and thinks for a bit with the, if I give it to them, will I become a target?
I like,
he has that look of
Can Doozle look somewhat threatening while he contemplates?
Do you want to threaten him? Okay.
No, stop. This is not going to be
fine. I won't threaten him. Just kind of loom a little bit.
Really just want to get out of this alive.
So making can you give me a diplomacy roll to
convince him? Sure. I actually have diplomacy. Can you give it a shot?
I was going to... I'm probably
going to
be bribing an officer. I don't really
want to
be that.
And if he's bribable, then hey, what else is he?
Yeah.
17. Yes. Okay, as long as your priest vouches for them, then I have no problem with that.
Our priest is MIA, so totes okay.
He's back in the town hall.
Yeah, he's looking after people in the cathedral and healing.
He's doing his priestly duties. He's too busy to vouch.
Not George. Depends on which priest. Some priestly duties are rather horrid.
Oh, can I be a priest if I'm upside down? Covered in water now?
Would a blessing from Callistra do?
Can I be a priest?
Not particularly. I'm not much of a follower of a goddess of insane revenge plots and sex.
But if they swear not, they're not going to do any harm to the town, lest Callistria strike them down.
Well, I mean, I could do that. I have yet to swear for each
of the gods, and I'm sure that that would be an interesting thing for them to break.
Oh,
I'm a pacifist at this point, apparently.
Yeah, no.
I'm okay with being pretty sure
at that stage the gods will just have a war over which one of them gets to kill
us. But either way it's not something you want to risk, right?
Well, hey, in that case then, they'll reward the one who succeeds.
If there's a particular oath you'd like them to swear that to just as a sign of good faith, I'm sure we can do that.
Oath of service of the town sounds good. They will serve the town.
For how long?
For as long as you're needed and you wear the badge.
And what happens if we're killed in the line of duty?
If you're killed in the line of duty, then you'll be given an honourable burial.
An honourable burial?
Yeah.
Sorry,
what does the honourable burial include? Sorry, but I expect to die quickly.
here's the thing. To guarantee your safety within the town, they need some sort of sign of good faith. Do you have any other suggestions?
I still look like a goblin, so I'm assuming I'll die very fast. So how's this burial work?
Right on time!
An honourable burial is you'll actually be buried in the graveyard, which is where we're heading next.
Do I get a gravestone?
You do. What's your name on it?
Is there a wake?
Depends on how many friends you have left.
Are there flowers?
Yes, I like flowers.
Drinking?
Only afterwards. Most likely because we'll have buried a goblin, so happy. Yes.
Yeah, Isaac.
Or maybe a bit of bar.
Maybe a song.
Dagger.
By the way.
A tavern song for fallen goblins in the line of duty, maybe?
Well, you'd be the first goblin to fall in the line of duty, so it'd definitely be worth the song. I'm sure we can convince Amiko. She's a very good songwriter.
Yeah, by the way,
so far.
Our group did kill a large amount of goblins.
Yep.
Now, I vaguely remember that there was 1 gold per goblin.
Per goblin ear you provided.
Goblin ear? They got 2 ears.
Yes, and you've got to provide the left ear.
How do you tell what...
You can easily tell which side
the left ear.
Yeah.
What happens if they didn't have a left ear?
Then, of course, someone's already claimed them. Shaylu sometimes says angry.
And it doesn't can't get paid for
price. Does exploded and ash remains count?
No. How many goblins did we kill?
11.
11 gold.
We didn't collect the left ears.
We know.
Yet.
Alright, but let's see what many goblins...
Oh, by the way, there's how many goblins on this
ship? Yeah.
Minus shit.
They don't have any, except for her, the others have all lost their ears.
Yeah, that's right.
They don't have either ear.
So now we know.
11 gold.
You lost.
When you get the ears, you'll get the gold.
Yeah,
is this where Willie sprints back to the town centre?
Yeah.
All that's there enough about money.
What a good monk you are.
Doesn't care.
No.
Enough. Right.
That's right.
Because the town folk know of that rule as well.
Yeah.
It makes sense as to why we couldn't find any ears. Like all those goblins.
It's like
and some of the goblins cut their own ear off before coming into town.
Help me. But so back to this question, does that sound like a fair deal to you, or do you have a counter offer?
Yeah, look, all my weapons. I'm going to start trouble. I don't need to stop.
I'm okay with
the
barrel plans.
Well, it doesn't stop the crazy elf who just wants to kill goblins.
Yeah, we're trying to get them to give you a marker that says you work for the town, don't kill me. Right, well, here, I'm going to give you my weapons. Give me the marker.
Can I keep my weapons, but I'll
Look,
take the
I'm gainfully employed if I need to leave to fulfill my employment.
Well, you sort of need your weapons to fulfill the employment.
Hmm?
You need your weapons to fulfill the employment.
I still work for the town, and they know that, so the chances of me surviving if I run away with
Which require you to defend the town against threats.
Alright.
Sometimes that is the elf. Until the troubles subside, and then we can
I don't know, I'm
kind of
keen to see how long I can go without hitting something.
No.
So is that the trouble today?
Hey, I have reactive shield. I automatically shield
now.
We don't
have any other jobs.
Me.
Are you bending me for words for this? I have no idea how long the trouble's going to last for, little one.
Yeah,
can't help
but if you're saying the trouble is in there are goblins in the area, that's going to last for my entire life, and I'd rather not.
There are goblins currently assaulting the town. As far as I know, they may be back tomorrow. Yeah, if they're currently assaulting the town...
That's the trouble you're talking about.
Yes.
As soon as the goblin incursion is over, we're free to go.
As long as you give back the thing before leaving
back
town.
Tomorrow. Yes, okay. I can agree to that.
Mm-hmm. And you might want to make sure the elf has left the town the other way first.
Yes. Mm-hmm. just best practice, good policy. Yeah.
I never leave town by the same gate she does.
Even though you're human?
She
won't expect it.
She's crazy.
Yeah, fair.
Bitch, just be crazy.
All she talks about is killing goblins.
So we're cool. Yeah, I swear to faithfully serve this town until the threat of the goblin incursion is over.
Thank you.
Yep. Cool.
And...
So like we can leave
I got a nice barrel. I'm fucking sweet.
Okay.
Yeah, we're in.
I'm going to have a nice barrel here.
I'm happy to leave tomorrow.
Oh, I mean, if leaving's an option, I'm also okay with that. But if we're sticking around, I'm okay with being here. Although, I'd like to meet the other five groups of goblins.
There are many goblins in the region. We've got more tribes arrived here than we expected.
Yeah, it should be fun.
Okay,
so we're done here?
We're done here. Let's
go to the cemetery.
Okay, so, come on, follow me to the cemetery. I'm sure that you can deal with this problem a lot faster than I would. I hate dealing with undead. Or the re-dead.
Well,
what
that's my specialty.
I'm
sending
the pressure.
Well, the newly risen.
Newly risen? No, it's the same.
I'm sure there's no vampires. So.
Yep. All right. Let's do it.
Okay. So. He says, worst case scenario, it's just some goblins. Best case scenario, there's a bunch of undead.
I'm just making sure.
That's the best case scenario.
Yeah.
I don't know. Can I feel insulted on both levels at the same time?
Well, look, if it's just undead, then they're rather mindless and they're not really going to do much.
Yeah,
but if it's a bunch of goblins
undead.
And they scatter, then we've got more
somewhat
of a problem.
Goblin.
They're a problem.
Goblins tend to burn things down.
Please, lead the way, good sheriff. We're here to help. If it's a bunch of goblins, we can go in and chat.
So, and as he's walking along, so what do you guys got in mind for your travels?
Oh, actually, we were really just wandering and passing through. Oh. We just got told to bring something here.
What did you bring? Oh, that's right, you guys brought that star thingy.
The star of Desna. Mm. Which was well received, and then all hell broke loose, but I hope everyone's okay.
They're dead people, they're not okay.
Oh, the people who took the star into the cathedral, I'm hoping they're okay.
Which was the Father Xanthius.
Selfish.
Yeah? No, the people who actually took Father Xanthius into the cathedral.
Okay.
Who were apparently working for the town.
Mm. Yes, they are.
Wait, wait. Father Xanthius, no?
Yes.
Yeah, but they have to take his
body. That was where he was neutral. That was where he was a bit curious about the person who took the star is his own client. Like, I thought he was dead.
Yeah, that's what I thought too. I'm like, what was it? Last time I saw him, he was down there. Stage.
So, that's okay. Do we actually know if this
I'm just trying to prove
cathedral?
We weren't like looting the body to take it back.
I did see you having fun with the mayor.
I think the mayor was having fun with her.
The mayor was definitely smiling a lot.
having a lot.
The
mayor.
The
mayor touchy.
Most of the people have learned to stay, social safe distancing from the mayor.
Out of melee range.
Ah, social distancing we see.
Right.
Is the term global mayor in common parlance?
It is here, yes.
Just checking. That makes sense.
So he is well known for his hands as well as the rest of him.
He shudders a bit. I try not to get him. He doesn't matter whether you're male or female.
Whose reputation precedes who? Willie's or the mayor?
Well,
Harry's.
I have no friends.
Hey!
Other than you.
Oh, no,
yeah, at least you look out.
There is one girl who would say otherwise.
And the priest. Everyone else.
That is
pretty
best.
The pretty body of your
shoulders. Shaylee would say otherwise.
It's shame.
Shaylee Spinder would say otherwise, he says, as he's walking along.
He said you have no friends? She says you've got a friend.
Next time
she says
you're
she says
you
she's your best friend.
You're
going to
be a dick in a box. Sure. Is that better? Is that
she's
best
telling
friend?
Everybody.
And how you single-handedly saved the town.
That's mostly true, but still.
You know, if you add all of their ages together... It's then really not underage sex anymore.
Oh. I don't like what you said.
I threw up in my mouth.
Think, yeah. I think at this stage I should just shocking grasp your testicles right now.
I mean, you could be the one taking advantage of.
No, no, it's not that. Parry one for consent, what's this?
Anyway,
Parry does what he's told.
The graveyard?
He sort of, you can see the shadow from the sheriff at the. Are you sure she should be town guard?
No.
But again, she's more useful to the town alive than dead.
Super good at miming.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Okay. He shows a bit more as he leads on.
Hey, I've never heard a single thing.
And so,
exactly.
That's a great town.
You're a spellcaster of some sort. Do you know who cast that magic in the town that killed all those townsfolk?
What? The magic in the town that
There was some big explosions in the town that killed a bunch of people.
Yeah, no, don't worry.
Yeah, I think that was the goblin.
Wow, this is your lying face in game.
last time I know, that wasn't actually a spell that was cast.
I thought it was.
Wow!
this is what the sheriff is saying. I thought a skull was cast. It looks like it.
I would
big scorch marks.
The
chemical?
Yeah. The goblins we found were carrying a number of incendiary devices. They were throwing them at us and throwing them at children and throwing them at towns.
They had at least one spellcaster with them.
They were throwing
them
at children?
The ones that you're talking about.
This is the first I've heard of this.
That's what he's talking about.
And I'd like to make a note of that.
I'm saying
that's never heard of that.
They had managed to gather fireworks and light them in their
hands. I tried to make friends.
There's
some toad liquors.
Sounds plausible.
Toad liquors out there.
Yeah, just checking. And apparently someone...
Can you believe I'm a goblin?
Did you see the goblins who decapitated the child?
Harry personally says no. Saw no decapitation of... trial through the massive crowd.
There is a group of
though we did find a dog wandering town with the kid's head.
Wait.
The lictor. I think it's sorry. What?
we've been cleaning up dead bodies all day.
I would shush.
No. Puppy's
beside
me.
You. Yeah. We have dogs in this town.
Yeah, no. I was confused for a second.
Yeah. One of the local dogs seems to be running around with his child's head in his mouth.
Has no one tried to catch the dog?
But have you ever tried to catch a dog that doesn't want to be caught?
Yes.
Yeah.
But
it doesn't always work.
We're not trained to eat it. Yeah.
I think we can all say we're equally horrified at the scenario, but we've been literally piling up dead bodies all morning, yeah. I'm not surprised that's happened.
A group Jews
are quite adamant. He says all he killed was goblins.
We've got to take more of these goblins out.
I mean, I'm not saying they did it, but they weren't too fast on any horse. That's all I'm saying.
Are they part of your tribe?
No.
But, I mean... I'm friendly with them, but
No, shush!
Wow.
We're not close in any way, shape, form. They're goblin, as I'm goblin. But look, they seem pretty happy.
You're digging that hole deeper.
Pretty cool.
They're a real goblin.
That's it, I'm not even a goblin.
Hey, do you want your fancy grave or not?
I would question the lick toads.
What's that mean? That's the worst.
I'm saying, if you're looking for decapitated children, maybe the lick-toed goblins just there to the south might have some answers.
Well, there is a swamp there. We can send some people. Though I wouldn't send
the lick toad is a tribe of goblins.
It's a tribe of goblins.
Okay, right. That's the goblin tribe we're playing.
That.
Okay.
I'd send the elf.
Because of the fact that there are so many of them.
That's why I said I'd avoid sending the elf, because you won't get any answers.
But the goblin problem will probably go away then.
Yes or no, she's been hunting them for years and never actually killed a lot of them.
I mean, hey.
But sending your townsfolk, they will reproduce really quick. They will be mauled as soon as they hit the swamp.
That's what I said. If I was going to send someone, I'd send you guys.
How many incursions has this town had with goblins?
Oh, we get them normally smaller scale every few months.
Right, so this is the biggest one that they've initiated.
Biggest one we've had.
Right.
Bloody but also the shortest one we've had.
So hopefully, because we made a bit more of a defense than they'd...
Possibly. Normally they don't leave. They normally die on our weapons.
Yep.
And this time they left. That was surprise. Why they left, we have no idea.
Can I make a warfare law roll to see if there's a strategy in place here?
No.
Just as we've seen the damage.
Who knows where to go?
Oh, for that one. Yeah, well, they tried to kill me. I'm going to let them die.
Can anyone give me directions? Wait a second, you're smart!
I will learn by the time I get to the last one.
And
in the process, I will eliminate a goblin army.
Whatever objective they set out to.
Okay.
And once that was done, I will eliminate an entire goblin army.
It seems like they left of their own accord. They got what they wanted done and then left.
There was enough of them to wipe this town out.
So, I guess we have to wonder, what is it they really wanted to do?
Yeah. Okay, so
probably take out the elf.
Yeah,
but they didn't do it, and then they left. So whatever they wanted to do, they did, and then they strategically retreated, which seems uncommonly strategic for the goblins.
Well, okay,
so he gestures around, set behind the cathedral there. Now this is where we would bury your hobgoblin when she dies.
This is a nice spot. Can I get the one just slightly under the tree? I like a bit of shade.
No, that one is reserved for the people who need to be buried inside a vault.
You're saying we're good enough now?
Yes. You get the sunshine, not the vault.
But also,
hey,
you have
a chance. But do I get a bit of shade from that tree? Hey,
no.
Margot, you actually get a burial. So
and also, you have a chance to prove yourself worthy of higher honours for your burial.
We're not finished about this tree.
Well, if you serve this down for 5 years, you can have shade. I'll give you that.
Moving on. There'll be a stronger creature about you because you'll be the first goblin.
I wouldn't mind a bit of shade. I get hot.
Well, by that say, she probably wouldn't be the first one today. She lasted 5 years. She'll be the
first
to serve.
First serving hobgoblin.
First serving, yeah. Anyway, but so, alright.
Okay, so he takes you to what appears to be a...
If you burn off that
energy. A 20-foot square structure.
Yep.
Standing under the tree where Margot was pointing.
Yep.
Getting nice shade.
And a vault.
Yeah.
Wow.
And a vault.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's really in the face.
Shade vault. This is swanky of swanky.
Yeah.
Yep.
And it's also near the wall. So it's got wall, tree, shade.
Location. Yeah.
And it'll cost you about $1.4 million and...
door that's partly open.
Yep.
Has a pool in the backyard.
While you're walking towards it, Hemlock.
Mm-hmm. I can
Sheriff Hemlock.
I'm sure he's on top of the piping system.
says that this is where we store the remains of previous caretakers, priests, and acolytes who serve at the cathedral.
Yep.
I'm sure Father Z will end up in here if we actually deem him worth burying.
So does the door normally stand open?
What do you mean
open?
By that, worth burying?
Well, we always ask a cleric of the religion to confirm that they are worth burying, because we wouldn't want to offend said God.
What actions do you believe that he has done that have offended said God?
We ask every fallen priest to
stand in practice.
Stand
it's not
practice.
Yeah. And occasionally we're surprised.
I don't know what you know.
Occasionally we're surprised and they say burn them at sea or leave them out for the carrion.
I'm more saying it generally.
Or donate them to the goblins. We've had one donate to the goblins.
Hmm.
But that was, the reason why we have a new cathedral. because the cathedral got burnt down.
No.
The old one.
So, are you saying the problem is actually in there behind that suspiciously open door?
Yeah, yes, well, I was about to say, is it normally open?
Door, and he gestures at the ground looking, and you can see that we have goblin prints here. And no. Some sort of larger humanoid as well.
What?
Tracker?
And I can confirm that there were, you've got a tracker. I'll let your tracker see if they can actually track.
Is it nature? Or
no, it's survival.
Survival. I believe it was survival.
I think someone has better survival than me, because I've got five. I think
Stefan did, because he had higher wisdom.
Yes.
But
somehow I've got better survival than you. How have I done that?
What's you have better wisdom!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, survival.
You're not particularly worried, because... Show us how it's done, masterful tracker. Yet.
Off you go, Ranger.
With said Poppy, I'm sure you're.
Hey, there you go.
24.
Okay, looking at it.
Oh yeah.
I got 19. That was amazing. Okay.
You have a glance, and you are able to confirm with him that six different goblins and one medium-sized humanoid wearing boots came through this area.
Oh, there's a humanoid.
And you think you might be able to recognize the boot prints if you see them again.
Cool. Ooh, okay. Oh,
nice. That's a good thing.
You got
to.
So I'll note that down. Recognizable.
Ooh, wow. Okay. So six. Goblins.
Dude is now going to be picking up everyone looking at their shoes.
And one,
is going to
be checking it's probably the fastest way.
Booty calls, literally.
Booty calls.
Prince.
Call for all booties.
Coming in or out of?
Call for all booties.
Heading towards it.
In towards. Going in.
Yep.
Wanted pair of booties.
And booty. I guess the next question is: were they shuffling booty, booty, zombie type? Were they booty, scratchy booty, skeleton booty, type? Or were they living walking type?
They look living walking type.
All down for the fun. Okay. Songs,
right? Living walking type.
What's the?
Going into a vault.
Vault. Thank you.
20 foot square. You said
it's vault number 20 foot across 13.
Each. Okay. While you write that down, I'm just gonna duck off to the loo.
Sure. From.
So, we're gonna try the whole press them into service thing, or are we just gonna kill them?
Don't kill the goblins, my life!
I'm totally fine either way, but pressing into service is fine.
Isn't but that nice as long slavery?
Slavery?
As long as we understand, it's we can't press them into service inside the city walls. If they're not gonna live.
Yeah,
they're gonna be like Deuce's kobolds.
Yeah, I'm just gonna say, look. I don't really want to kill you.
Run and be free is not an option?
No.
Run and be free.
Join us and live.
Yeah.
We
could be a Pathfinder with our own personal army.
Look, I've known of one rogue who had a personal army once before.
Stories of Veggie Pygmy Warlord.
Who's taken over many cities now.
I'm sorry, are Veggie Pygmies particularly dumber or smarter than goblins?
They're actually...
Everything's smarter than goblins.
So point being, we could easily have a goblin army follow us and be the first Pathfinder group with a goblin army.
The
only reason why
Pathfinder group, we're not a Pathfinder group.
Exactly.
The only
we're
reason why
Doom's
kobold died is because they're
band of heroes.
Band of heroes.
Private contractors.
Because I ran.
Some of them were.
I know, but I rolled bad on my initiative.
With a goblin army, I mean, it practically wipes itself.
Let's go.
And look,
I'm prepared to give it a go.
Zed is actually prepared to give it a go, but we need to understand. We need to understand.
Slavery?
Yeah.
That's right. Band of heroes.
What's psychopath?
What are you doing?
There's a lot.
You are a psychopath. You want the elf.
Capitalism.
What are you saying?
And you've been openly saying you want to gouge out eyeballs and rip out beating.
But not.
It's what I do. It's my style. It's what it's all about.
So the walkie seems like current walkie or like
it's free choice. They choose to follow us.
For what?
Normal walkie.
Well, looks like it was walking with the goblin.
Slavery. Right. And it's fresh.
Become
a slave or follow us for free.
Yeah, but I've got elves.
I think you've got a hard sell there, but I'm willing to hear
they're
it.
They're goblins.
Yes.
Okay, everyone, now that we've identified this, it's time for our deputies to show their mettle and gestures towards the door.
Can I ask him one more question?
Apparently we're deputies, okay.
No, there are two people wearing...
Yeah, so those two.
Oh, yeah.
All right. No, As far as you're aware, does this mausoleum vault thing have a, like, tunnel exits underground?
Not that he knows of, but you've got two people who can see in the dark, so they should obviously go first.
Cool.
I can see.
I did also clarify something with the rogue stuff. It's not trap sense 10 foot, it's trap sense whatever the GM thinks is a reasonable distance.
Mm-hmm. Also, this time if I scream goblin,
it doesn't actually have a limit on it, it's perception.
Kill. Just so we're clear.
So,
you sure?
Goblin means don't kill.
You sure?
Well, I mean, you could do it again anyway.
Sit by the gate.
Medusa follows him behind you.
let's give the goblins a chance to prove their mettle. If they can be trusted, this is a good chance.
Stay in yelling distance.
I'm not letting you go in there by yourself.
Yeah, yeah. Do you follow us in behind?
It's a 20 foot by 20 foot building.
Yeah, it's still 16 squares.
Mm-hmm. You're still following behind them.
I'm not going to try and crowd in through the room, but I'm not expecting them to just go. Hunting in.
Parry's going to probably stay at the door.
Do you want to keep the door open?
Just making sure nothing
this
comes
out. Not. You're probably about 40 feet from the door when the sheriff says this to you guys.
Yeah.
Yep.
So he's saying we should send the two deputies in to investigate first.
No.
He's not saying they should enter. He's saying we should send them in to investigate.
Mm-hmm.
And you already said no.
It's just we're here as a team. That all I'm saying is we're here as a team. So we will. Go forth and investigate accordingly. Like,
okay, he put out his hand. I'd like my things back, please.
No, I want to go and knock.
Okay, well, if they're not going to follow his instructions,
no, I'll go through. Yeah. I'm going to knock.
We're going to follow your instructions as well, because that's how we roll.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, as a team, of course.
We're a team.
So while I'm having this conversation, I'm just going to walk towards the door and give it a good old.
We're all going. We don't want them to go alone.
That's all.
It's all of you doing. It basically says I'd asked for just the deputies to go forward, mm-hmm. and you all want to go. So they're not deputies.
I'm obviously not understanding something.
He's saying that he wants the goblins to prove them. So this is their try. This is their trial.
It's a test.
And deputies. So he says hand over the
bag. So this is like a rite of passage. I totally misunderstood. I thought this was like the quest line, and he's sending them to their doom.
Well, very possibly. But we're going to find out.
This is now them proving their badge now.
Yeah.
Right. At which point it's like, quest, Margot?
I'm knocking on the door.
Yeah.
Cool. Hello!
Hello!
While they're having this discussion, we speak in.
Yeah, we're knocking. We're gone.
You have our full support.
Like, yeah.
Good luck.
Anybody there?
Okay, so you go up and knock, stealthily?
Honestly.
As suggested?
Was it suggested?
It was investigate, not. Barge in.
We're not kicking the door down. You said kick the door down. I was going for the more diplomacy.
That's what I sort of asked.
Yeah.
I wasn't
going to knock the door
down. I know.
That was
2
out of
10
for that one.
Do you want to sneak or not?
Because he said sneak, you said knock.
Well, because he said kick!
I asked, Marco, do you want to kick the door in?
And I said, no, I want to knock.
We need to keep a list as to what investigation means right now.
Knock.
So the tracks are leading up to the entry, right?
I'm happy with sneak, and I thought the options were.
So is this investigate A?
Roll a
I think we've gone all the way down to Z.
What's investigate 9?
Please do it right then up and then we're going to investigate the scene.
So, we walk up to the door, the tracks are obviously leading up. Is there anything else to be gleaned from around? Do we need to, do you like to smoke?
Give me a perception roll.
I will make
one of those food.
That's true.
As soon as Morgan went ahead of me on my
phone. I'm about to roll. If it's a bad roll,
I'm sorry for the confusion, Martin. We just misunderstood.
I got it. I just got it as you guys were saying that.
Which is why he has been specific.
Yeah.
He says, you can't test someone if
the whole. I was on the same path until I realized it was a small confined area. So why do we all need to be in there? We don't have to be.
14. So probably
our experience with tunnels is not good.
I think all of us misunderstood.
So I was just making sure.
Our experience of doors and then enemies on the other side are also not good.
Yeah, but that's why the goblins go first, right?
Making sure things are out of the way.
No, wizards go.
We're clearly the
shit. I just got a natural
20. You got a natural 20?
Yeah. You saw something, so it's okay.
Good timing.
Okay, so you sneak up, looking inside. You see what you can obviously determine to be two skeletal warriors standing just inside the door.
Whoa.
Unless you need to be on sentry, but they don't react to you.
That's not goblinish. Oh. But apparently they're goblin friendly.
But also that's not what we saw walking in.
Yeah, but once they're inside, they're the skeletons.
Do you guys want to use...
Which is why they have worries about undead.
Do we get their attention?
I think we can probably just keep walking.
Hello!
Okay.
Hello!
I haven't moved yet.
And remember, they did say investigate, not be suicidal.
Just keep on walking. If they attack us, then we say, right. Help, Kimono, help!
They're 40 feet back, are they?
Do you have message?
No.
You can always walk back.
Pretty sure we can just yell.
There's two skeletons. Would you like to keep going?
Coming back,
I'm going to keep going.
Did you come back and report?
I mean, I wasn't going to. Did you really want to go back and report? Are we going to do that every time? Or do we just run back when we're going to die?
It's 25 feet. Two turns.
Seems like a lot of effort. I mean, I'm still not going to follow.
You're technically still not an initiative, so really you can do whatever you want.
There's two skeletons. We're going in.
Well, look, if there's two skeletons, you can all go in. At least you can be untrusted to report in and
see,
not
I think if we all go in, then they might actually activate,
might just be able to sneak in through.
That was the test. He says he'll leave it up to the group to do. As long as you can actually be trusted to do what you're asked, that's the main thing he needs of deputies.
Yeah.
If you can't do the basic thing, then you can't be a deputy. You may test you again later, but he'll tell you when he's testing you.
Skeletons just had swords or no weapons?
They had swords.
So, I reckon we can go in if they attack us, then we scamper off. But if we all go in and just start cleaning house...
Are those supposed to be there guarding
the vault? I feel
like
we've got through because we're goblins, so they're not
we don't have any
goblins.
Undead that we know of in town.
They all come in.
They appear and we basically destroy them.
Okay, just making sure.
We just keep
we normally ask the priest to do so. We're currently having a priest shortage.
So
sounds like a good plan.
Who in the town would you know would be able to raise dead?
He shrugs. It's not a skill that we encourage.
Maybe the Bigfoot.
No one's publicized.
So if someone says that they raised dead, they would probably be one of the people buried here.
This is one of those towns.
What are what towns?
I have no idea.
I grew up in Kermagar. Necromancy is...
He just shrugs. Shudders. That's a horrid place. No one ever really wants to go there.
It's a very interesting place to survive.
Survival is not the word.
She was very excited to go back home.
You barely exist in that place.
Ooh, Baron.
But yeah, if we all go in there and just start testing herbs, it's going to alert whatever's further down. We can get in without,
so
one thing
we'll
you did
going.
Know is
we'll
that
there
was you couldn't see any exit in there. It was basically because you got a natural 20, you could see the skeletons and that whatever was in there also left
the same way.
The same way
through the same door, but went away from it the other side. So they came in one side of the thing where you followed in, and then they came out and went out the and around.
Right.
So what are they guarding in there?
Yeah, what are they even in there for? But either way, there's not supposed to be undead in the town, so that's problem one to deal with.
Mm.
Then following the tracks to wherever they went to next is problem two. Yep.
Yep.
All right. Let's go deal with the skeletons.
Okay.
Let's get now, with that. Zombies, like fleshies, are for fleshies are for slashing, bonies are for bashing. Right. So, blunt weapons.
I cast spells.
Yep.
I don't do both.
Just whenever we've got weapons, so like the. Slashing
weapons,
got a staff, not so much.
And in this version of the game, magic doesn't do any different for most damage reductions. Nothing has you need magic weapon to hit. Some things have immunity to non-magical stuff, but that's a lot rarer than I have resistance to slashing.
Slashing, bludgeoning, piercing. Yeah. But it's the same rhyme that you said in Kemaga.
Yeah.
She said in Kemaga.
Yeah.
Fleshies are for slashing.
Chris pulls out the banjo.
Look, hell of a club.
The only thing I've got is the whip, and it's only a foot.
And Hemlock, Sheriff Hemlock, and she says, catch up with me in the town square when you're finished. Let me know what happened.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to go try to head off the elf before she heads this way.
Understood. Thank you for your time, but so we'll deal with these and then we'll follow the tracks to see what happened next.
If you can find out, that would be great.
Okay. So, skeletons, shall we?
Mm-hmm.
I suggest we just walk in slowly, get as close as we can surrounding them, so we're...
Well, should we head in and try and get towards the back? Because they'd
obviously be running in head first.
That would be what happens to start encountering.
No, yep. No.
Lift him up, you get these little legs pumping.
Harry seems quite eager.
Drop him down, let him be the roadrunner.
Now that's an effect.
I've already learned one.
Have you though? Have you?
He said he learned once, it doesn't mean he's learned again.
There might at least be another 33 exactly. Learning sessions on not to go first.
Another 33. Right, okay. Well, let's do this.
Yeah, I think if it didn't react to them,
yeah,
if they can get in
first and get as far into town.
But also, don't you have a light spell as well?
I do.
Why don't you like fire that up and chuck that in anyway? It doesn't need to stay dark in there, does it?
Yeah, I'll throw dancing lights in there.
But it's more fun if it's dark.
And you just strobe them?
Yeah. Yes, and I want
skeleton dancing party. What's up? What's up?
Give me a beat.
You are the beat.
You need to get one of those snare drum things attached to your foot.
Yeah, yeah. Get to the jangle bells.
Hold the suit.
Yeah, that's it. All right, let's do it.
Okay.
Let's have some fun.
I get out the light mace that I have specifically prepared for this sort of crap, because arrows and swords don't do much.
I have staff.
You should get out.
I probably have a weapon, yeah.
You should get out one of your
There's very few simple, agile, finesse weapons.
Don't I have
light
a better
mace.
Weapon for that, I think?
That's what I got.
Yep.
And eventually, when I get my monk dedication,
fists.
Okay.
You've got a pipe.
Yes.
A long sword.
I'm
really looking forward to your powerful fists.
Right hammer it is, I guess.
Do you need anything to eat?
I'm good.
Okay, so as people move up, could people give me a perception roll as your initiative? Because
here we go.
Not these guys. Literally nothing to these guys.
Couldn't have saved that for an attack roll.
I got it.
Okay.
So did you say perception or?
Yeah, yep. Perception.
So what was Zed's?
25.
25.
Oh, well.
Apparently, you want to be the quick one.
Mine's 8.
In you go, Zed.
Didn't Parry.
Parry got 18.
18. And what did Duzar get?
16.
What did Quest get?
11.
What did Willy get?
7.
What did Margo get?
15.
Okay, so Willy said that with just a sad tone.
Duzar still can cuss from the knockout blow from the elf.
He's still here.
And apparently you might not get a chance to relieve your tension.
I'm sure I will if I put my mind to
it. His eyes are glazed over. 1-7-22.
Okay, so, Zed, you're apparently, you are speedy today.
Cool. Well, Zed, like, we were pretty much just outside the door, right?
And you can see the skeletons outlined in flashing lights.
No worries.
So is this speed coming from your bard?
Sure. So it's a 20-foot room.
Yep.
Are they closer to the back or closer to the front?
Yeah, either side of the front doors.
So like right in front of the front doors, like okay.
Waiting.
Zed is going to use mobility to walk through the front doors.
Yep.
And I don't know what their reach is, but then use mobility to get to the back as well.
Does mobility
prevent
attacks of opportunity?
It prevents reactions, yes, okay. That's correct. It's the only reason I took that second level fee.
Okay, so you move into the back.
And then use perception once I'm actually in the room
mm-hmm.
to see if there's anything else of note. And this is where I get that 2.
Yeah. Or even better, 1.
7, so 13.
Okay.
It's dark.
Having a look in there, with the flashing lights and strobing and stuff, it looks as if one of the burial plots has been ransacked. Okay, now moving on to
The Beat Master Parry.
DJ Hotter.
DJ Hotter. I am the party tank and the party
is
DJ.
Is he the DJ or is he the Mr. Lighting? Because I think we have DJ over there.
Yeah, DJ's the iron lighting.
The light board.
Who needs to go anywhere else? Just follow this park and have fun. Like, how do you think I can't sell this to the goblin slaves?
So can I see
totally not going to be slaves.
So basically, you're just going to invite them to a rave party.
Yeah. Yeah. Quite clearly
constant rave
live by your
party.
Party.
Party. I'm sorry, they're goblins.
You have to
how is that not going to fly?
I know. So
be free ravens.
One action, right?
That doesn't have to be sustained. Does your dancing lights have to be
sustained? Oh, does my dancing lights have to be sustained?
One of those questions is your spell.
I'll look it up then.
Oh, no, I can look it up while you're dealing with your other stuff too.
Yeah.
Because that will
It's 327, so.
Cool.
I've wrote the page number down here so I can just flick straight to it.
Yes, it is sustained.
Okay, so one action. Yeah. So next two actions will be casting.
And then next thing you know, it starts to rain on you.
Just tired now. And
it's raining.
Yeah.
Out of just.
Underground.
Well, I didn't say it was
I'm
a clear sky.
Okay, alright. Interesting.
Well, he hasn't entered the pleasure.
No.
The only person inside is
that guy.
Skeletons don't count as people.
They have
Zed, Zed hardly
counts. So discriminatory.
Oh, hang on. Oof.
Oof. You go running in and we just close the door. Walk away. No.
Ouch!
Assholes!
Yeah. You're not the savior of men, this guy is. Saves some people's lives.
As when Zed turns to skeleton guards, that didn't work. Notice they haven't attacked me.
No, exactly. It's like, damn, we didn't manage to draw him in.
Mm. Alright, guys. Maybe he's too goblin.
It's gonna be a rude surprise for the next person who comes in, though.
They don't attack people!
Yep. But you did see, like, Zed Goblins. Zed used mobility, so Zed, like, kind of, like, slid, like,
did the whole
sliding
sneaky,
through.
Like,
did the whole...
Zed did
shuffle,
the dance
shuffle
move.
Yeah.
It's all about the dance. You gotta rave it. You gotta rave it hard.
You raved your way through.
So, the music you're playing, is it actually Bardic Inspiration, or...?
He hasn't got to it yet.
He used to struck up a tune.
He's still doing and dance,
got
dance
that
moves.
Far, or is this
Goblin.
Like a silent disco?
No, I am playing. I just haven't actioned up.
And remember,
well.
It's not in tune either, because
sure.
He's intentionally said it's not in tune.
Dance for me, dance for me, dance for me.
I'm casting electric arc.
Electric arc.
Yep, electric arc.
So, to the two skeletons.
There are at least 15 feet apart. So one is... So they have a gap of 5 foot between them, so...
Mm-hmm. So 5 foot between them?
Yep, 5 foot between them.
How far away are they from me?
How many... They would have started at about 20 foot when you guys...
Yeah, that's fine. So it's range 30 feet. I can target two creatures.
Yep. That's why I was just giving you those stats.
So
yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I was making sure.
I'm assuming you're closing the line right, and then...
They do have to do a reflex save.
They do a reflex save? Mm. Let's see how badly they can do this today. First one is a 15.
Nope.
Second one is a 22.
Yes. So the second one makes
so
it.
Fine.
So it's 1d4 plus 4 damage.
Yeah.
First one takes full damage, second one takes half damage.
And resistance is... Yeah, sorry, you do half damage and then there's resistance.
Correct.
In some of the other games it was resistance and then half damage.
Oh, wow.
They get dealt
7
damage for the full one.
Mm-hmm.
So
and
then
3
because rounded down.
Yep. Okay, 7 damage for the full.
Mm-hmm.
You sort of scorch one and the other one just arc into their armor into the ground.
Damn.
Interesting.
Hang on, just scorched it?
Yep.
Jesus Christ.
So they obviously have resistance to electricity.
Cool! And Zed's like, noted.
Yeah, no, so Harry is also like,
I get this full view.
Such a shame these skeletons went out of their way to attack us.
Cool, so that's my reactions.
Doozer!
I thought I was trying to two people. Never mind.
I don't really want to stand between them so much as beat them into a pole.
Or do you want to move into a position where you can hit both of them?
Sure.
I thought they were 10 feet.
Well, that was a 5 foot gap in the middle, and they were taking up 15 foot to get both of them.
I'm a better dice.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so there's three squares between them.
Okay. Now, so
they're literally either side of a 5 foot door.
Do I have to do a movement to get up to them, or am I right next? Okay,
yeah,
so
move to get up to them.
Movement to get up to them.
At which point they both swing at you.
Whoa!
Ooh, they have a reaction for coming into this.
No, they had a ready action.
Oh! Fair enough.
It didn't trigger because it's a reaction.
Yeah, it's a reaction.
That second level feat has paid for itself.
Yep.
Okay, so the first one hits an armor class of 14.
Nope.
Second one.
Oh. I'm gonna probably make you re-roll up.
You sure you don't want to land flat on your face again?
No, I really don't.
Hits an armor class 20.
Yeah, so it's a hit.
Just a hit.
Just a hit.
Better than being flattened.
Giving 7 points of slashing damage.
Ouch.
As you see a bunch of orc blood come flying away from the front doors as you wait in.
Ouch.
There you get to act.
And you can still finish your movement.
Alert not to go do that.
Because that's your movement pretty much waiting right in between them.
Yep.
So if you want to move past them, so you've still got range on both of them.
Yeah.
Other people can then still come in.
Yeah. I move.
I didn't use my
I guess to the one that actually hit me.
Electricity
out of the way of the doors.
Well, the thing is, other people can come past you.
Either way.
So you move in. How far can you move?
Plus also, do a lot of us have electricity options?
25. Okay, no. You can stand between them on a 25, or 20s, you stand just in front of them when they attacked you. It'd be a 30 to stand on the other side of them.
Oh, okay. So, but I can be out of the way of the door.
Well, anyone can walk through.
Oh, okay, that's
you don't
fine.
You don't block allies.
Okay, that's fine. So the 20 foot is to get in front of them. Mm. They still attack me though. Yeah. Fine.
Because they're attacking the first non goblin who moved into their threatening area.
Yeah, I figured that. Yeah.
Oh, so we could have sent the goblin.
But you didn't know that.
Yeah, no, I know.
That well, they also didn't. They rolled. I'm gonna hump prey. On
do you still have it, or do you?
It's a concentrate.
It's not. It dropped. It's not limited.
It's not limited.
No, it's not limited. It's but if you already have a hunt prey and then you choose a new one, the old one disappears.
Yeah, cool.
It's made with the same action.
Yeah,
but it disappears.
You don't need to consciously drop.
Yeah, it got.
There are some other ones floating around.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Your last hunt prey got unconscious.
Yeah, this implies it like is weird wordly because like you can have it active as many times on a single target as you want.
Once you activate it, you have a focus on that target.
Yeah.
Until you then choose to focus on a different target.
Or drop it completely. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then refocus on the same target if you wish to.
Doesn't do anything extra, but you can.
Well, it gives me the opportunity for the next time I can just go, that's my hunt prey.
Yeah.
And go
double tap.
Yeah. I quick draw my great. Actually, you said slashing's not that great.
I'm assuming you had your axe out already.
Oh, you're assuming I had my axe out already?
Or you had whatever weapon he said, because he said, I said
flesh is for slashing, bones are for bashing.
Yeah. So I have piercing and I have slashing, and that's what I've got.
Okay, so the assuming is you had your weapon out before you went up to the door, because everyone had the equivalent of a free round to prepare.
Right. Yeah.
Oh, does that mean I'm in my style?
If you wish to be, nice.
Okay. Well, okay, my great. I would have had my great axe out because that's the one that does the most damage.
Yep.
And bash the one that hits me.
Bashing and slashing.
Is it?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. I checked. It's good.
Maybe
I
know, so much. Weird, most of them have a bit of double.
I love you.
I can verify that. Yeah,
that's
alright.
Okay. You climb onto a shield.
Ding.
A shield.
Should I re-roll up? Because you just have your claws out.
Not after the
horses in the corner.
I think we discussed really that. After results being given,
that
shouldn't
be. If you basically call out what you find on results, that should be the end of the re-roll.
Yeah. Oh, right. Yeah. Sorry.
You can choose to re-roll before.
I usually ask him to math for me, because I don't math that great.
Okay, so that is your second action. You have a third action if you wish.
Wait, so walking?
Oh, sorry, you've hunt prey. So you're
walking, hunt prey,
So you've done all three.
The table is not in your favour.
What would Margot like to do? Both skeletons are still going after...
Margot says in undead, which I apparently know now.
Okay.
The good news is, though,
in an intimidating, you can still using use my intimidation, I tell the skeleton to stand.
That you can only do tiger
stance. Okay, you mean intimidation roll.
So you can still use your bludgeoning attacks.
I mean, I think I want to do
and
it.
Get your
I mean, I could do it as a free roll.
In what language?
Undead.
Necro.
Necro.
You want to say in necro?
Sure.
Mm. Do you know necro?
I do.
She picked up multilingual as her feet instead of the other one.
18 plus, I think, like 7?
Yeah.
That's a big number.
Okay, so everyone around you hears this horrid language being said that's just sending shivers up their backs. It's basically, it's on the equivalent of running nails down a chalkboard as far as everyone's concerned.
And my character's like, yeah.
Yeah, that sounds
so unless you know Necrol, you have no idea what she just said?
No, but it still sounds cool.
Did it work?
You don't know?
Oh, come on.
Besides, people might destroy them before they have a chance to respond. That can happen.
Well, come on, guys. Okay. I want to see if it works.
So,
don't kill him.
You want to activate a spell at this point?
What?
Do I just, like, hold my other...
Yeah, I'll... Forbidding
if
ward.
If you're asked and you're waiting for a response, that basically...
Yeah. I mean, like, I'm not going to do anything with it, but, like, do they go into, like, a hold vault?
No.
Okay.
You lose them. Unless you specifically say, I'm going to do something if this happens.
Well, then, if they respond... So, all right. So, after that... I give them one of, yeah, that's what's up. Yeah, that was cool. And then if they respond, my reaction is to do one of those ridiculously unnecessary large bows of, you're welcome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll forbidding ward Doozer and put the skeleton on the left. And then put up the Inspire Courage.
And the music picks up.
20 years from now.
There it is. Ding, 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 ding. And you feel inspired by the beat in the rain as you're getting wet. Your string instrument's getting wet.
Oh no! Oh, actually, rather than play that, because I don't think I'm going to stand there and go, you know, if I was a suspicious bastard or a sneaky bastard, I'd sneak into the crypt and make two skeletons or a couple of skeletons just to distract people I was sneaking around the town.
Mm. Funny thought that.
Yeah, I was about to say the rains are probably getting rid of those footprints pretty fucking fast.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, but so we're here now. We'll just do this instead.
Well, apparently you get to act before any of the skeletons have been beaten though.
Yay!
Mr. Bludgeoning, it is. But you do slashing attacks with your stance, don't you?
No,
not just. He can. It's not limited like the crane stance.
No. I'm gonna move into the. I'm gonna move into the room.
Yep.
No
attacks of opportunity because they've reacted.
Somebody else has already done it. Yeah, awesome.
Thank you for soaking.
And I'm going to.
Yeah, kind of hurt.
flurry of blows, okay. One of them that has hopefully not been injured.
Okay, yep, that's the one that Doozer's attacking.
Awesome. For my free action,
so little bits of lightning arcing down its armor into the ground.
Yep. As my free action, my character sort of looks at Doozer and goes, "This is how it's done."
No.
Oh, come on.
That one.
So what did you give him for your natural 20?
29.
So the crit card as well.
God.
Cheesy.
Roll down. Mofo.
7 points.
Doubled.
Whatever.
And you're doing a bludgeoning attack?
Yep.
So which one did
and
you
so you do 12 damage?
7 doubled is 14.
14. Okay, so it doesn't really matter that you did a numbing blow on the creature because if it's
already kind of numb.
Immune.
4 hit points.
4 hit points. 4 hit points. Oh. So I smash it. And I go.
Would you like to swing it with the other one with your other arm of your...
I will.
I want to see if it stands down.
I will.
Miss.
Okay, they had an initiative of 4.
What?
They had an initiative roll of 4. Right. You don't have a penalty on this because you've still got out your full attack.
It's your mold. It's the flurry. It's
yeah, but your flurry is only on one person.
Is it?
Yeah.
No. Okay, in which case then it would be...
Flurry is make sure unarmed strikes. If both hit the same creature, apply damage as one go.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure
you can apply them on both.
Okay.
So then is that your full attack?
Oh, okay. 14.
Unfortunately, that's not. But you do have a third attack now. But it's at -8.
No, I'm not going to do that.
No, didn't you? Because you had to... Oh, sorry, because flurry is one action.
Yeah. So no, I don't. Oh, I moved...
Flurried.
And yeah, okay, no, I don't.
And cheesy one line.
Yeah, cheesy one line.
Cheesy one line, no taking out one person.
So. Yeah, dudes that might have words for you later.
And then ask for your name word.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, it's just jelly.
Skeleton has an attack jelly. On Duzer.
Yeah, that's what you said.
Oh, it's an attack?
Which one did you attack?
The one that Duzer
armor
attack.
Hits armor class.
Ah, that's my 10. Shot.
Is that the one on the left or the right?
No.
It's the one. That's all that matters.
No, hitting armor class, 14.
Left. Nope.
And attacks
it's
again.
It's getting better.
No, but it's minus 10 now.
Yeah, no. Hitting armor class,
12. Nope.
Yeah. Nope. So, it's still doing pretty well.
Swish was
good.
Yeah.
It's like, hits your armor
swing,
each
swing,
time.
Swing,
smack, 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 smack. And then it is Zed's go. Unfortunately, he didn't listen to you.
Apparently not. And you know what? Now it's going to die before I get to fight it either. So
yep.
Fight us still
like,
has.
You're snuck in.
No
you're one of them get taken down rather than being released. One punch, one.
Sorry, is that the look that I'm actually reading on your face?
Yes.
Please let me.
Dude's just
let
like,
me.
Looks at him,
please
looks at
me.
The other one, looks at you, just like.
I want to kill this thing.
If Duzer has another kill stolen, he is just going to lose his shit.
Yeah.
Time
yeah.
to kill the still.
That's what the kid said, too.
Yeah.
You don't know that.
No, I don't. And because I don't know that, and because I actually don't think... See, here's the thing. If you've been hit, you've actually been damaged.
Yes.
So, look, you know what? I'll let you have it.
You let it go.
Yeah, I'll let it go. I'll use my actions to like. I think they've got seriously. There's like spell, physical attack. Like just put his fist through the whole freaking ribcage scenario.
But no heart rip.
Yeah, and Zeus is like hanging out to do
out.
It.
Yeah,
so you know what? I consider that under control. I'm going to investigate this thing that has been ransacked to just find out what I can.
Give me a perception roll. Are you perceptive fire away?
17.
Yep. 17, okay. I will give you a name as you're currently looking through stuff with the flashing lights. So it is
die.
I've also got dark vision.
I know, except the
color.
No,
that's
right.
That's
right. So it is
Parry's go.
Sorry, I'm just trying to.
So,
my action is obviously.
I'm not kill stealing.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not kill stealing.
I noticed.
There he is.
hands up, everyone who saw it coming.
Yeah.
It's not kill stealing.
I was
she had the shot missed.
Yeah.
She didn't attack that one. She attacked the other.
And
yeah.
Then it's not kill stealing at all.
Which the one
she
I damaged? So you'll be stealing my kill.
We will argue the semantics on kill steal etiquette. After the combat.
So, electricity didn't work. I am
going to you did damage this one with electricity.
fair chance of damage.
Yeah, I'd like to point out, on your way home, the engagement's off.
What do you mean on the way home? I thought he was walking.
Well, just go to the cemetery, get a real
skeleton,
don't let it beat it up.
You know what's funny? Yeah, I'm driving.
Yeah, I'm going to steal his car keys.
No.
Yes.
I'm going to cast Ray of Frost.
Yep. Amy's like,
it's not even your kill. I damaged this thing.
Amy's like, it's going to be hard to drive with broken fingers.
Yeah, sounds like someone's getting mugged on the way to the car.
Just slightly.
Hitman's being called already.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So Ray of Frost on this.
Dude spends his reaction.
Yeah, do the whole thing actually just like save this skeleton just so he can kill it.
Just checking in with you.
22.
Just checking in with you.
22 versus AC for the raid.
22 is a hit.
Kill.
And what sort of damage is it? Cold.
It's cold damage.
I know.
It's probably resistant.
Dealing 6 points of damage to it.
Okay, so I think you see it sort of bone sort of crack a little bit, but it's still going on.
There you go.
One. Someone, yes.
I knew.
Resistance cold 5. Resistance electricity 5.
Yeah.
Far out.
Yeah.
Which is why the other one took no damage whatsoever. Yeah,
oh my god, oh my god. If you roll minimum damage on your great axe and it has slashing 5, you are going to lose your shit.
So, Doozer, let's see how... Alright,
he changes his hump pro.
I mean, yep. Is it okay for make her reroll till she gets a 1? Is that allowed?
Reroll comes out as the best result.
This time.
Yeah, but it can only
But is the best result kind of in the stage?
I don't have to move to hit him, do I?
No, no, right there.
No, I'm right there. Good. Good.
And whiff.
Maybe.
Or 14. No, 15, sorry.
No, I didn't play it.
He hasn't played it.
Oh, that's right.
He didn't play it.
I made a comment instead.
Do you want to call out the number or do you want to reroll?
I've given you the number. It's whether you take it or not.
It's up to her to call it out.
No.
I'm going to reroll that.
Okay. Reroll. You get the higher of the two rolls.
Can we challenge?
Come on, go on.
Yeah. Not 20! Yes!
Okay, now we want to reroll.
So what, 28?
28. So 28 does make it a crit.
Yes!
Oh dear, you're
we'll
gonna
see if you do something
in here.
You're gonna whack it into the wall and bring the house down.
I want this one!
Smack! Kaboom!
Okay, so it's your slashing attack?
Yeah.
Slashing, yes. 10 plus
4. 14.
Doubled
is
28.
Minus.
Very
good. But you know what? It looks spectacular.
Okay, so.
Minus 5 is 23.
As you swing, you're just staring at Zed as you're doing this. As you're swinging through, it just shatters right where you hit this cold part in the spine, and you see it flying in two different directions, and these little cold shards of bone go flying around the room.
Very Evil Dead 3.
Yeah.
And you still haven't looked away from Sharp.
It's like, that's you!
Cold steel the whole time. The blue steel.
I was half tempted to run up and hit him with my staff.
You were out of actions.
Oh no! But as in, instead of right. doing my thing,
you would have taken the out if you had done that.
Yeah.
It had 2 hit points.
Oh, I know.
No resistance versus bludgeoning.
Oh god! Boom.
Yeah. I don't care. I'm so happy right now.
I'd like to point out, he did 1 point of damage.
I know.
Yeah, he did 1 point of damage.
I don't care.
That's like winning the biggest game in the world by 1 point. Yes. Still one, fire.
Okay, so
he's like, I finally killed something correct, and it's not a child.
I'd like to point out, no one at this table knows that she's coming back.
I know.
Do you?
Yeah,
you're the only one who knows.
Yeah. Goblin!
Even Doozer doesn't know.
I'm actually the only one
who knows.
You're the only one who knows she can't.
Oh, that will only end well.
The fate of your innocent
super
now
awkward
head of
Margaret. Hey, is that the one you just mentioned?
Is the skeleton skull still together?
And he's still going.
Okay, my character monkey stomps the skull and looks around, looks at you and goes, Willy for 2 kills. What did you get again?
I'm pretty sure I have an
Doozer,
action left.
Get good.
I have an action left.
So Willy's
swing
the
target.
Willy, that still counts as 1.
it was the same skill that you're the one you knocked down.
Nice.
Don't go.
Fine.
You killed yours. This was obliterated.
As long as the skull was still there.
There's no ear to collect the bounty on.
It's gone, man. It's gone.
Oh, good. All right, but so that's addressed.
Yeah.
Was there anything of interest in here? Otherwise, we needed to follow those
tracks. Before they left.
So as you're looking around in here.
Yep.
At least get the name of the coffin.
Yeah, absolutely. But also inviting other people to search as well.
Yeah, like, yeah.
While they're doing that, I'm going to try and track the footprints.
Okay, so you notice that the person who has been ransacked has the label Ezekine Tobin.
Is it can
the entire the body has been taken from him.
Whole body.
Everything that was in here has been taken.
Nothing left in the coffin, like no compartment or anything.
Egyptian style, nice.
They're basically body snatched.
We sure it wasn't one of the skeletons?
Not subtle about it.
Did we accidentally kill Ezekiel Token?
And you don't think so?
And when did Ezekiel Token die? It wasn't like this 5 years ago, Mark.
That's
for the
a bit racist.
Marks carvings on the door or anything, was it?
You don't know it was stolen by goblins.
It was when the cathedral was originally burnt down.
Oh, for God's sakes, I hate coincidences like that. They never end well.
While they're doing that, Quest is going to try and track the footprints.
Yep.
Quest is definitely
okay. You step outside and go squelch, and you look down and you can't even see your own footprint once you lift it up.
Whoops! Can Harry have a try as well? Sure. Even though it's probably been raining for quite a
while. Is the sheriff still outside, or is he?
He went back to head off the elf killing deputies.
His new deputies.
Yeah, Quest. Do you know anything about this Ezekiel token?
20, not natural.
So
20. Okay, having a look around, you can see two or three prints fading quickly in the water.
I'm going to say quickly, guys, this way.
And by the time you reach the wall, you can't see any more tracks.
But they go to the wall.
They go to the wall.
I got a natural one, so I'm assuming I saw tracks in a different direction.
Which way would you like to go? Oh, you head back into the back of the cathedral.
Yeah,
that's
course.
Obviously where they went. There's a broken window up there, and you do remember a window being broken and fire in the cathedral at some point. You think this is where they must have come in this way?
Yeah.
So do you want to start climbing up the back wall?
Not really, but I feel like that's what's going to happen. So yeah.
Give me a climbing roll.
Athletics.
Oh, at least I have that.
You do. You are very athletic.
Probably
you
won't
are
die immediately. Yeah.
Disadvantage for wet.
17 plus 7 is a big number. 24.
Okay, and everyone just turns around as you're at the wall. They went this way. You see Margot scaling up the back of the church.
In full chainmail.
Margot!
Yeah! Strapped up.
Margot!
Weapons bristling in the listening ring.
Margot! Wrong way.
But you sure it's this way?
No.
Margo knows best.
I mean,
here you go, here's one.
There is no evidence for
this. Hey, Margo! There's an angry elf up there.
I'm gonna do a judgment. Is there a judgment roll? Like,
perception. Sure, perception.
Do I believe that maybe I'm wrong? It seems unlikely, but now that I'm up here, I'm not obviously
seeing.
It would
be deception versus perception.
Because no one can climb as well as you can. There's no way they could come up here.
Should I say that there's actually, you'll be seen by the angry elf?
11 on my judgment.
Do I need to do a deception?
Okay, so it could quite easily be an angry elf somewhere around here. you've never seen them, but you know that there is some sort of angry elf around somewhere.
An angry
beach. Oh, that's right.
Yeah, you didn't see what took you.
And then I was
She's seen the elf jumping around town, but she's never seen it in person.
I've never actually seen it attack me either. So am I even afraid of the elf? I mean, I don't know.
Well, if
well,
they
are 11, I'm not sure.
Surely we would have told her when we like untethered her from being upside down.
She still
down.
Hasn't seen her.
Question.
It's like the devil one.
Question.
So no, is an 11 a judgment of I'm probably going to follow
it's
the correct way or the not correct way? I mean, yeah, but it's like a 50-50.
I'm just waiting for you to realise that you're climbing like 50 foot up a cathedral and I don't know what you're going to weigh down.
Jump up.
You realise there's no way the others can follow you, so you're probably safer with the others.
Yeah, I'm thinking 11, I'll be like,
Angry goblin killing elf.
I'm happy for you to slide yourself down the wall because you're
going to I'm the one going, I'm going to... Can
she figured out how to get up there, she can slide down.
Can I attempt to jump to the other wall?
It's not like it's a cat up a tree going, I get up here, I have no way how to get down.
Can I jump to the other side?
Get the ladder out.
You want to jump to the...
Can I? Is that even at all possible? Is there any way I would believe that?
Between you and where he is on the wall is most of the graveyard.
No, I'll probably start.
Please jump head first in the graveyard.
No,
please.
There might be an open pit down there you can go
She's
for.
She's doing it herself, not me.
No, I was like, is it one of those records?
Don't encourage her.
I could jump that. I could make it. You or am I like,
You can do it.
Cool. Slide down.
No, damn it.
A standing leap covers Running exactly over. 10 feet.
Yeah, I know.
So, I'll follow the correct direction now.
Okay. So, Just so you know, you have managed to do the desecrated vault side story.
Okay.
Which you'll be able to find more out later.
Yep.
You have actually managed to complete part one of the Rise of the Runelords.
Nice.
Book one.
Yay! Mm-hmm.
And you're currently in part two.
Nice. Yay!
Cool. Noble heroes.
Local
heroes.
Yes. Where you get to interact with the local heroes.
Oh, now's my
turn. Oh, shit!
Which you already interacted with a couple of.
There's more.
Wait!
One of them is.
I get to be the angry goblin killing elf now. Yay!
And one of them has a set of steak knives.
One of them is the barkeep.
The bard?
Yeah.
The bard barkeep.
Amico.
Which is she's also the tavern owner.
Yep.
So.
Yep.
And another one is the angry elf.
Angry elf.
Yeah.
I can relate.
Yep.
I got angry once.
There are a few other things going in there, such as further Willy adventures. That's actually listed in here.
I am trying to save you from yourself.
I am trying to save me from myself.
No, you're not.
No, you're really not.
How bad
could
it
be?
Slide him down the river. How bad could it be? He's just getting up and
just so you know, they actually have a section called The Shopkeeper's Daughter, all about Shay Liz.
Let's go, Willy.
You can't escape this.
Marriage.
You will forever be
marriage.
The guy who likes younger kids.
I just think you can actually have Kroll do the ceremony for you. Yep.
Shotgun winning to a whole new
level. You know him and his bows. You don't want him to pull his bow out.
Well, that's for sure.
But
kind of where he ends it.
But I thought we'd end it there with the thoughts of what you might come.
Fair enough.
And that will give hopefully some time for our Kroll to show up.
Yeah.
Oh,
we'll see. Oh, no. I don't think it's going to happen.
He might be online from home.
Oh, online from home, yeah.
Online from home is fine. But he won't actually be here in person. It's just that he had a horrible connection, and we couldn't actually hear him properly, and he couldn't hear us.
Yeah.
So it kept dropping out, even though we just dropped it back to audio.
Yeah.
So I will put this into end credits.
Emmy, just so you're aware, the Z considers...